Party people, can y'all get funky? Suicide and force, can y'all get funky?
What is up, guys? Wallow J here, and I'm here with my co-host.
Heart of War.
What? Saint Art of War.
I don't know what that is. And we also have Matadora Roja, a.k.a. Sherry.
Shari.
And producer Chris behind the screen.
Yo.
Miglino is not here today. He is sick.
He's got the herpes.
In his throat. So he's having...
Wait a minute. He's got herpes in his throat?
I mean, that's what I imagine.
can we guess how he got it?
Maybe it's not herpes. Maybe it's just he's cold. He has a cold.
Oh, okay.
Maybe it's just... We might have been exaggerating. Guaranteed we're exaggerating. He probably just has intestinal issues. He did cook for himself this week.
Oh, so that's a problem.
He cooked for himself this week, yeah.
That's
yeah.
Where the nausea came from.
We know he will eat, you know, raw chicken wings.
For reals. He's like, bro, hey, listen, man. I got this new recipe. I was like, word, what is it? He's like, have you ever had chicken before? I was like, duh. He's like, yeah, but have you ever done that shit raw? I was like, seriously raw? Like it's cooked with like.
It's the new keto.
Some sort of thing. And he's like, nah, dog. Like, right out the package, drain the blood. Good. I was like, no, bro, it's not good. Have you ever heard of the Somalias? I mean, Salamel.
Somalias? You talking about the Somali pirates?
Look at me. Look at me. I'm your foodborne illness now.
Talking about fucking that one up.
Gotcha, man. I didn't fucking know it. I did that shit on purpose.
For all the,
I'm a fucking genius. I'm a little deeper than the average.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Chicken pirates?
I set up my goddamn jokes with fucking stages and
shit.
You
could have fooled me. Shit.
Stages. Everything's not just penis and anus over here, man.
Oh.
I gotta kick it out in the steps, man. So you might not get my jokes till 2 days later, but oh, that's what the fuck he meant. That's the key.
Comedy. He's got inside jokes that listen, only man, he gets.
Listen, I was watching Joe Rogan and he explained it all.
Okay.
I was like, you know what? I gotta do it like that.
What did he say?
Motherfucker, you obviously you're not listening, now are you?
No.
You'll figure it out.
Okay. Fine.
I got jokes. Listen, I got jokes that will make you think that I'm roasting you, that I'm actually roasting somebody else at the same time.
Oh, yeah, let's hear one.
No.
You ain't got shit.
You may think it's about you, but it's not about you.
If the shoe fits.
It's not about
lace
you.
Lace that motherfucker up.
Although you'll think about it. You'll think it's you.
I won't think about it. I won't even think about it twice.
Yeah.
I'll be like, whatever.
That's because, you know, you're Puerto Rican. Yeah. You know, machismo, too, you know, man.
Wait
a minute, that's like what's that? That's Scarface. So that's from,
yeah, no shit. That's Cuban.
Cuban. Yeah, I think they're probably harder than Puerto Ricans, maybe.
You think so?
I don't know, at least in that movie.
Oh,
in that movie, they're pretty gangster.
Hey, how did you get that scar? I was in posse.
I was in posse, man. He's like, listen, man, I don't break any. There's two things I don't break, my word and my balls. Or what'd he say? What'd he say? I don't break that down for me. Go ahead, do it.
No, it's all right.
No,
it's okay.
There's two things in this world I don't bust. My word and my balls are a break. I was like, oh, that's hilarious. That's funny, man. So
speaking
of
Scarface,
shit.
I haven't seen it in forever. I think I'm due.
You do?
Yeah.
Due for a Scarface?
Yeah. Don't you watch it like every year?
No. Are we supposed to?
Yeah. I said, guy, you're supposed to.
Oh.
That's like bro tip number 73.
Bro, I had no idea. Man, I've been fucking this up the whole time.
You know, it's almost time to watch Die Hard again.
Oh, then now that I watch every year. That's a Christmas movie.
Christmas
movies.
Yeah, well, this one is a guy movie that you must watch every year.
I had no idea.
Yeah, well, no idea.
I'm glad I know now.
Yeah, he's not even paying attention. He's all up in his phone and shit.
Listen, man, let me tell you something.
What are you doing on your phone? Tell us.
Let me explain. Do you see this thing right here? Okay. Right here?
Uh-huh.
Listen, man, I am technologically savvy and shit, man. I'm about to break this thing down for you.
You don't know a gigabyte from a kilobyte.
Let me tell you something, man. Let me tell you something. I made $87 in a day, but I didn't even do anything. Bitcoin, motherfuckers. Bitcoin.
And the earth is flat.
I'm up in that shit. I'm all up in it. I don't even know what it is, but I make money off of it. I don't know. It's cryptocurrency. And yeah, look at $15,760. Ooh, for a Bitcoin.
What the fuck? Can you put that away for a little bit while we do the podcast?
No. I'm on it right now. I'm adding payment method.
The guy at work that's on it, he's got 3 Bitcoin, and that's all he was talking about the whole day. And we were like, all right. He'd be like, oh, it's up to 16,000. Oh, it's up to 17,000. Oh, it's up. And we're like, dude, are you working or not? And it was all day.
Jesus. I understand now why the posts are going up. I think one of the Templanet guys had a post talking about if you're using the word Bitcoin, unfriend me or some shit like that.
Well, he's going to be all upset here in about fucking 1 year when everybody else is like, it's okay, but I'm multimillionaire.
Well, maybe he's got Bitcoin, but he's just not talking about it.
Maybe. You know, all over maybe Facebook. Not. Maybe you know? Not.
Bitcoin's become the new vegan.
Kind of seems like it.
Maybe.
Everybody's all up in the Bitcoin nuts.
Who fucking knows?
They want to try it, but they like the meat.
The credentials you provided were incorrect. Okay, I got to figure this shit out, man. Oh, we got to figure this out.
This podcast is going to be great.
Yeah, I'm on it, motherfucker.
No, you're not.
I know I was gone last. I know I was gone last week, and you guys are all partying up, talking about sororities and fraternities and liabilities, all these E's. I'm changing it up. There's no E in this bitch.
I missed that. I was at urgent care.
You was at urgent care, getting some antibiotics for the
kiddo.
Kiddo's son. Yeah, that's a horrible situation.
I think the best part of last week's podcast was B-Mac calling in.
It was.
Oh, I miss B-Mac.
Yeah.
So funny. Yeah, that's funny, B-Mac. You're a hilarious dude.
Man, B-Mac.
You're funny. You're a funny guy.
B-Mac came in with a hammer and just started smashing.
He did. Oh, you didn't listen to the episode?
What's up, B-Mac? What's up with that?
No, it was a busy week. What's up, B-Mac? I couldn't even do anything.
God damn it.
Yeah, he made fun of Art.
Oh.
He was great.
It was.
He probably did better than Miggy.
Get a man while he's down. It's all right. You know what I was doing? I was out there supporting 10 Planet Brothers and Sisters, you know, across the nation. So.
And freezing outside.
So I don't even feel that bad. No, it's good, but it's freezing over there now. There's a bunch of snow over there. Fuck that.
Hell, it's snowing there. I think I sent y'all the photo. It was 5 inches in Atlanta.
That sounds below average.
Of snow.
Damn
it. Are you taking Miggy's spot on just derailing jokes?
Ayo! Yes. It is my job today to come up with the sucky jokes.
Good job.
Damn.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, it's going to be much simpler. It's only going to be one stage joke, so you'll get it right away.
Ba-dum-bum.
Oh, yeah. Ba-dum-bum. Compared to your complex jokes that you tell us now and we're supposed to get it next week.
It's the inside jokes.
Yeah. He's on inside jokes. No.
Listen, on the inside jokes, you ain't ever supposed to get it, motherfucker.
It
you
sounds better on the inside.
You got to be on the inside to get that shit.
Then you're not supposed to tell them if they're inside
jokes. No, bullshit. I'm telling because the people know. They may not be here right now, but they know who they are.
Yeah, okay.
What?
Yeah, exactly. What? Nothing. What? Nothing at all, sir. Did you guys see the news about Dustin Hoffman?
No.
No, what's up?
He's now back on the news.
Yeah, he's got caught in the net.
Yep. Apparently, close to 40 years ago, he molested somebody on stage. Oh, well, they were doing a play in New York or whatever, and he got accused of sexual, you know, molestation.
What?
And I guess this woman at the time was 17, but so let's see, 1983 to 2013. That's what, 40 years?
Yeah. Yep.
And add another 4, so 44 years ago, and now you're coming forward?
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Aren't there some bandwagon at this point?
There's a lot of that shit going on. I don't get it. I don't, like, why can't we just say what's going on at the time, man? What's going on, guys? What's going on? What the fuck?
I don't want to take anything away from, like, the victims, but at this point, it's a bandwagon issue.
Yeah, 44 years? Come on. That's a little late. You know,
you want to get it off your chest before you die? Like, what's the point at this point?
Then leave it on a piece of paper in your will or something saying, you know, Dustin Hoffman molested me, by the way. I'm out. Peace. You know, I mean, 44 years is just...
That's a long time to let it rot on your mind.
Yeah, come on. I mean, at this point, it's like all these people that are coming out 30, 40 years later, I'm just looking at it like it don't even matter. If you didn't come forward back in 1983, don't come out forward now. Like you said, you don't want to take anything away from the victim, but at the same time, it's like you should have said something back then, not now.
I mean, how is it going to be productive at this point? What do they want?
Well, not to mention that, it's like, how do you punish that? You can't punish that. You can't prove it.
Statute of limitations.
You just got people just saying random shit. Like, I can just say, Wallo, you touched my ass like 2 days ago, and it really bothers me now. He's like, what are you talking about? I didn't touch your ass. You're like, yeah, you did 2 days ago. And they're like,
I probably did. Have you seen your ass, bro?
I know.
It's tight.
It's pretty amazing.
And muscular.
I've been doing squats, man. The Bulgarian bag. I've been doing the squats.
That thing is no joke.
Shit is no joke. People be talking and they don't understand.
You know how most people bounce quarters off of people's asses? Ooh. I bounced a dollar off of his ass.
Oha.
It's so hard.
So good, man.
It went up a dollar.
It works. I'm in that shit, dude. So Bitcoin is $15,828.75 for one Bitcoin.
It was 19 on Friday.
God damn. This is time to buy, son. Time to buy.
I don't have that kind of.
Ethereum is $466 and Litecoin is $158. You can get on that Litecoin and Ethereum if you got it.
And this is where people are tuning off.
I'll take donations.
No, they're not tuning off. You need to fucking listen. You need to listen. But listen, man, did you also hear that the Bitcoin and all this stuff right here? Because you know they have to mine these coins through like computers. But it costs a lot of energy. So what they're saying that actually.
What?
Why are you laughing?
Because you burped onto the mic.
Oh, yeah. So that's part of that one stage joke that everybody likes. See, I made y'all laugh.
No, you had to try it. They're mainly laughing at me because as soon as you did it, I picked it up and I kind of raised my head up.
Wilson looked over the fence.
Yeah, make sure you weren't choking to death.
Anyway, Money Monster, go ahead. What were you saying about the Bitcoin?
No, fuck you guys. Just saying. Whatever.
All right. Hitch. Well, back to your the sexual harassment and assault stuff.
Yeah.
You know, you say, why are they coming out now? Why didn't they say anything then? You know?
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, you know, now with the climate the way it is, you know, maybe back then you wouldn't have gotten the justice you were looking for.
But well, what kind of justice are you looking for? There's no justice right now.
Oh, there's total justice now because you can destroy somebody's entire career right now with just a few words. With just words.
I believe.
In the public opinion.
Okay,
that's
listen.
All you got to do.
On top of that, yes. So, yeah. So that's bad, but I just bought a Litecoin. $158.
You know, Christmas is around the corner.
Oh, shit. Do you think it'll make me enough money to where I can buy everybody a gift and I don't even have to really spend money?
You can get everybody a Litecoin.
Probably not that quick.
You have to get an account.
Litecoin's been going up, but it's been a slow progress.
If you have any questions regarding Bitcoin, please forward to Art.
Yeah, Art. Art has become a profesh right now.
In a matter of, 12 hours, he's become the professional.
Mm-hmm. Listen, man, you don't want to ask me about it because
He's always on his phone looking at his Bitcoin.
No, listen, man.
He doesn't have time for you.
Hey, I just bought that Bitcoin and I'm up $100. I just bought it right now.
Yeah, I'm happy for you, bro.
As you should be.
Because you're like a little girl right now. So happy and giddy.
Look at the charts, man. It's only growing.
Oh, well, I can't see it, but you could put it into the camera and show the people.
Yeah, make sure you show them that QR code or your wallet.
So it can be stolen easily. Yeah.
It's happened.
Oh, I'm sure.
I'm going to have to make sure mine didn't get stolen. Yeah. I don't know where that money's
going. So anyway, going back to what you were saying, you can destroy somebody's career now.
Yeah, super easy. All you got to do, 44 years ago, this guy touched me. And now in the court of, because it's not in the true justice courts right now. But it's the court of public opinion and outrage. And nowadays, that's all that matters.
Well, here's the thing. What evidence has she provided for everybody?
Just her testimony.
So basically, you're going off of somebody's word.
Yes. That's all that's been said. Okay. Now, granted, he has had some other people come out and say.
Meryl Streep, yeah.
Well, Anna Graham, Hunter claimed.
Damn, a guy?
No, Anna.
Oh.
said that he assaulted her in 85. On the TV film Death of a Salesman.
I can't even remember what I had for dinner last night, let alone what happened to me.
That's crazy, man. What if they fake that thing?
Well, here's the thing. Dustin Hoffman is how old now? In his 70s, maybe?
Oh, God, at least.
You know, he's had a long career.
I mean, are they going after money, like settlement-wise?
It's like he's made so much money. It's like, I'd be like, fuck you. I'm done. Anyway, I don't even act that much.
I think... I don't know, man. So like, I just don't know what the person has to gain from that. Like, it's already over. Like, you can't prove it at this point in time.
Well, like he said,
you're just throwing out nasty allegations. Like, well, wait, but if it is true though, I mean, you know, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Well, fuck, man. 40 years later is not the time to say it.
Yeah. Yeah, but you're getting something now. You're getting to destroy that person now. Yeah, you may not be getting money.
That doesn't take anything away. It doesn't change the past. It doesn't change the fact that you've held on to that. He's not going to lose his
money that he's already made.
The only thing I can think of is settlement-wise. Like,
nah.
But you can't go to court. There's statute of limitations.
Can you pull up his net worth and see what he's worth?
Do you think that has anything to do with it? Like, why they would want to do that?
Well, I mean.
I mean, I'm asking.
No, because if you're going public, you know, it doesn't matter. Because you would do it behind closed doors.
True or not, I don't understand why coming out 44 is anything.
I don't know. I just find it stupid that you wait 44 years to say anything.
Let's see. If
this I don't even know. Like, how much of it do you really remember? Like, is it exaggerated now, or is it not exaggerated now? Is it worth? Like,
well, what's it like?
His net worth is only estimated to be 50 million.
50 million? Mm-hmm. That's it? Oh, he's broke. Yeah.
Well, I mean, that's your estimated net worth. That's what you can provide. That's not what he has. You know, his net worth is just like your net worth is your potential, your potential of income and things like that. They also do, you know, your endorsements, your commercials. You know, this is his net worth is what he can possibly bring in if everything is going perfect, you know.
Well, he's been working since the 70s, right? So let's say that he does have 50.
Oh, no, I think he's probably been, he was born.
The graduate was the 66?
He's maybe? 80.
He's 80.
He's 80. He was born in 1937. So I'm sure he probably got into it before.
Yeah, because I think the graduate 70s. Was in 1966, if I'm not mistaken. Or 69.
Hey, yeah, most definitely 69.
But, I mean, he's probably made a ton of money anyway.
He's been in the, basically kind of started, he was on an off-Broadway production in 1960. But he was a classical pianist during his time at college. Okay. So he was doing, you know, piano shows, I guess, back then when he was in college.
So technically, he's been working since the 60s.
Probably since the 50s.
Okay.
You know, 55, something like that. But, you know, I mean, there again, even still, what do you get? What's the... Here's the thing, and it sounds horrible, but the more it happens, it just... Yeah. I think everybody's seeing that there's a window of opportunity to get some fame.
Feel like it's desensitizing
the... That's exactly what he's doing.
Completely.
Because I see it every day now, and it's like, whatever.
Multiple times a day, you'll see something. When or somebody new comes out.
When I was going through what I went through with my ex, it was like, at that point, because I didn't openly come out when it was happening, I did it as I was getting divorced and stuff like that. So it was like, it's my word against his now. I don't have the proof, the physical proof, although I had his admission, he had medical records and what he did and everything. But even then, I still couldn't even go to the cops and say, this is what he's done, this is what he's been doing, because of the fear of they're not going to believe me because I didn't say it when it happened.
And that's a kind of a big, big fear that most people have. But waiting 40 years definitely doesn't help any. Waiting 10 years, waiting 1 year, that doesn't help.
Well, especially really not with the climate.
Go from the get. Yeah, and the climate right now is just...
It's easy. I just feel like it's a bandwagon now, though, and it's taken away... From those who do go through it, because now they're not going to want to say anything at this point. So many people out there saturating that market, but
yeah, that's good.
The issue.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, it doesn't have any impact at this point. It's like 44 years. Come on, get out of here.
Well, it may not have any impact for the person saying it. They may not get anything out of the deal, but the problem is that it does have an impact on whoever. Because here's the thing. There is no, in this scenario, there is no, you know, innocent until proven guilty.
Yeah, you're guilty until proven innocent.
Yeah, you're just crushing legacies.
Yeah. Same thing happened to Danny Masterson. He was, he's in the ranch with...
Not anymore.
Yeah, I know. He got fired from the ranch because of sexual allegations that happened 15 years ago. Mm-hmm. And the police investigated 15 years ago, and he was clear of all charges. But now he's being accused, you know, the allegations are coming out.
Yep.
So he got fired from that show, even though the cops cleared him of any wrongdoing.
Did you guys see that one thing where homeboy, what's his name? That news anchor guy got fired for like
Matt Lauer.
Matt Lauer, right? And then it has two girls from the same network, like, with their hands on like a lifeguard's chest, like doing the same stuff, like groping this guy, literally groping him, like right in front of him. Like that's a kind of weird double standard, I think. And they didn't get any kind of like flack from that, even though like they posted that and they should, you know, people found it, dug it up. Like, look, same thing, same, just the gender thing was switched. So like, what kind of double standard are we dealing with here?
Well, it's the same thing with the one of the chicks from The View grabbing, I think it was Robin Williams's balls in like some sort of an event. And because she was...
Well, that explains it. That's why he killed himself now.
Oh, my God.
He's like, goddamn, Whoopi, keep your fucking hands to yourself.
It wasn't Whoopi. It
was, I'm just kidding. I don't know. But I don't know.
I forgot her name. Guess.
The only one I can remember is Whoopi. Because I liked Whoopi Goldberg in her movies like when I was younger and stuff. But as I got older and she got older and she started like getting real kooky and shit, like I can't really handle her anymore. So she was like, oh, Whoopi Goldberg's in? I was like, yeah, I'm not watching that shit. I remember her in Ghost. She was good in Ghost.
I liked her in Burglar.
In Burglar?
Yeah, and Jumping Jack Flash.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. She was good in Jumping Jack Flash.
I like that Nun movie.
Fucking oh, Sister Act?
Sister yeah. Act.
Sister yeah. Act 1, 2, I watched that all the three, time 4, like,
9.
So,
yeah, yeah. So I can't handle her anymore.
Well, that same double standard's been pointed out in a few things, like BuzzFeed back in the day, you know, before they disappeared now.
They're gone?
Oh, yeah, they're bankrupt now. The whole Hulk Hogan thing.
Now, you mean Gawker.
Was it Gawker? Okay. BuzzFeed is still kicking because they've still got a YouTube channel. But they've posted things, you know, bashing men talking about women, about, you know, how, you know.
Before you proceed, mm-hmm. did you know that Hulk Hogan's attorney financing for that was done by the owner of PayPal?
Mm-hmm. Because they went after him years ago, and they tried to out him as gay.
So it was perceived as he was trying to take revenge.
Well, he was. There's no perceived. I mean, they tried to expose him as being gay years before it all happened.
So what if he was gay?
Yeah. So what if it was gay? But the thing is that it's not your choice to, because he didn't come out and say it. He didn't get the option to come out and say, yes, I am gay, or anything like that. They just printed it, produced it, so then the question's out there. So, yeah, I would see where that would be revenge.
Anyway, go back to what you were saying.
But anyways, they posted a huge article about all the bulges, the Olympic bulges that women should be checking out during the Olympics. You know, swimmers and stuff. Yeah, legit. And all it was pictures of guys' dicks in their swimsuits, you know.
Who posted that shit?
This was Gawker.
Gawker?
Yes.
Good Lord.
You know,
well, I mean, the name is Gawker. So,
but the thing is, you know, nobody caught any heat about that. Nobody said anything about it. It wasn't like there was a big major outcry. But if you did that with women, you know, say you took pictures of all the girls in swimsuits or the Olympic or the booty track and meets, you know, people would freak the fuck out.
Yeah. Hey, guys, real quick.
He just what's it up to now?
Yeah, he just made a dollar.
$943.97.
All right. Good job, buddy.
Just saying. If you don't know, now you know.
If you
and you will continue to get updates during this podcast about how much money Art's made today.
Yeah. I mean, if you want, you can
go ahead. He hasn't made it because he hasn't sold it.
Yeah.
That's true.
So what we're going to do is we're going to put a...
Need to get a track.
We're going to put a tracker on our website, LRTLK.com. We're going to...
Don't listen to him.
We're going
to
put a page. And we're going to call it Art's Bitcoin.
Hate on haters.
I'm happy that you're making money. Sitting on your ass.
Yeah.
Hey, everybody should strive for that.
I know.
No, we need ditch diggers and shit.
I mean,
keep digging ditches.
It's, you know, capitalism at its worst. You know, of course. That's what people say. Anytime you make money, people are upset that you make money.
They're like, listen, man, I should be making money. Well, you should not be making money.
The people that are mad, exactly, are the ones that are not making any money.
Fear of making moves. That's what they have. They have fear of making moves. You know what?
If my boy's making money, I'm happy for
him. I might be taking this $1,000 that I put into it, $1,158 that I put into it, and just be throwing it in the dirt. I don't know. But right now, I'm making money.
But isn't it nice that you have the freedom that you get to choose if you want to invest?
The man is a risk taker.
It's a risk taker. Risk taker. I'm like a fucking commercial.
Well, why don't you?
I'll make you want to buy shit.
Well, cut a promo for Bitcoin now. Go ahead.
He has been for the last 26 minutes.
Like an actual, you know, this.
How long have we been doing this?
26 minutes.
Well, I made a lot more than that, than $26 in 26 minutes.
I'm glad the market's going up now.
Do you see something here real quick? I'm like one of them, not like an onion layers where it gets worse as you go down, but like one of them cake layers where he's like,
So are we going to get
chocolate, some good feeling, some more chocolate, maybe a little vanilla cake.
Sounds like cake.
I want some good feelings too. I want some of those donuts that we were talking about
earlier. Yo, we're talking about these artisan donuts. Where are they from?
Good dough.
Good dough.
But do they have gluten-free? Shit,
bro. You get, you have to have.
Know. I will check.
You have to have milk or coffee or something to cut that, man. It's thick.
It's heavy. Is wheat?
Heavy is wheat the name of gluten? It.
Wheat is gluten.
Yeah, you can't have none of that. You need to stick with those.
Sorry.
No, I'll check because
protein donuts from Lean.
They are artisan. So and I think they have. The problem is not a problem, but just the thing is they don't have like a standard menu. They change. Good dough changes what they're making constantly.
They're good dough. Maybe.
Yeah. I think they have made gluten. They have done a gluten free.
Yeah, now they've made gluten. Donuts.
Well, they've made gluten-free in the past because I follow them on Instagram and I've seen them because they post, like every day they'll have a new donut, a different donut for like maybe their lunch or their breakfast. Like one day they did a whole donut and chicken kind of in place of like chicken and waffles. So you actually got, you know, a donut with a fried chicken kind of thing.
So, yeah, now that we're talking about rapey chickens. What?
What?
Rapey chickens? What the hell are you talking about?
I'm reading this thing over here, and it's like Charlie Sheen has sued National Enquirer over Corey Haim rape allegations. What do you care, Charlie Sheen? You're on the way out. Whoa. You're on the way out, dude.
Do you know what's going on,
though? It's a tabloid.
Do you know what's going on, though?
Corey Haim said Charlie Sheen, like, diddled him?
No. First of all, you didn't even read the article, so stop it.
I'm looking at it right here.
All
right.
No, you're not reading the article.
I'm reading the title.
Corey Haim, first of all, is dead.
Listen. All you need is titles.
Wait, hold on.
Oh, yeah. I was thinking the other Corey. What's his name?
Feldman.
Yeah.
This is like the third week in a row we've mixed them up.
That is a weirdo. Listen, man. That's what happens when the kids get diddled and drugged.
Listen.
In shows business. First off, I don't understand why parents are not even around their children when they're doing these show business things. Like, if you're a parent, you should be there watching a kid. But they're like, trust all these like strangers, like because they're actors or something like that. Dude, they make believe for a fucking living. You can't trust that. You can't trust that. You got to be there watching your kids. Like, watch your kids make believe with all these adults making believe. And another thing too, like, let me go on a small little rant. Why the fuck do people like hold these like actors and stuff like to this like esteemed level? I'm like, they're like making believe, dude. They're not like fucking rocket scientists or physicists or anybody like, you know, I don't get it.
They provide a service.
Entertainment.
Yes, that is it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But they're not like, I mean, I get it. Like the Angelina Jolies and those out there are like really trying to help with like conservation, you know, they're adopting kids, they're doing good stuff for their money. That's good. Right. But I don't see why, like, they're a huge political force. They're like a big political force. Like politics are like, hey, listen, man, we need a sponsor or even like Nike. They're like, you know what? We need a name that people really kind of get behind. And the people are just like little fucking sheeple just kind of go like, oh yeah, well, Angelina Jolie's doing this or fucking Michael Jordan's do this. This is what I got to do too. It's frustrating to me.
Enough to where someone goes and has 50.
That was Photoshop.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. But yeah, that was horrible. Disgusting.
And she looked like death.
It was Photoshop.
Oh, thank
and makeup.
God. She looked horrible. That was terrible.
But do you understand why Charlie Sheen?
I don't know why.
Okay. Because last month.
I got excited there. Sorry, guys.
The National Enquirer alleged that he raped Corey Haim when Corey Haim was 13 years old. There's no evidence provided.
He said allegedly.
They reported it.
Allegedly.
You can't report allegations.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And the dude is dead. He's dead. He can't say yes or no it happened.
So if I was Charlie Sheen, fuck yeah, I'd be suing them too.
Yeah, I would sue.
Defamation of character.
I would sue for defamation of character.
Let's not get crazy here.
Hey, I know he has no character.
He's got no character. Or
he'd be like, listen, man, I like a few things in life, and let me explain to you what them things are, okay? Now, hookers, yes, I like hookers.
I only raped 15 other boys.
Stop, I'm not done yet with my list. I got it's a short list, it ain't gonna take long, hold on. Hookers, yes, I like hookers. Do they have AIDS? Sure, fuck it. Coke, I like the Coke too. Weed's okay, you know, I like that. Fast cars, good, women. Fast cars, fast women, fast Coke. Little boys, I'm not too keen on, you know what I mean? Like maybe back in the day
when they were 13,
maybe if they're 13, I don't know. Maybe
there's only 15 of them. Corey wasn't one of them.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that's not a part of the list. God damn it. You tricked me. Okay. You tricked me. It's just cocaine hookers. It's all like,
Tiger's blood.
That's what I made of.
Winning.
I was going to say that.
Winning. Can't be winning. Kids don't have it. Fucking. He's made a deal with the devil.
Actually, until I saw this article that he was suing the National Enquirer.
He's been out of there.
He's been laying low.
Well, I thought he was dead.
No, he's almost dead. Have you seen him?
No.
He's on his deathbed.
Yeah, is he hungry?
Man, he was looking rough.
Yeah, he's looking hungry, huh? Skinny, huh?
Yeah.
Damn.
I heard that he had to stop taking his medication.
He's just like, you know what? Fuck it, dude. I had fun. I have kids.
If that's what you call fun, I guess, but.
Well.
What, cocaine and hookers?
I saw him on that addiction show a couple times.
Going through the DTs?
Strung out, yeah, bad.
He's like,
he kept sneaking out too. Like he just.
Listen, man, a tiger blood's addictive shit, you know?
That's why you do weed.
Have you had the tiger blood?
No, man. No, look at me. Do I look like I have tiger blood in you?
He's going to get the Bush accent going again.
Man, that's what you get for acting stupid questions.
Listen, that is the Callahan accent. It's not the Bush accent.
I think it's Bush.
It reminds me of Bush.
All right.
Well. I don't know, except for...
I don't know what the Callahan accent is. I've never been to Callahan on purpose.
Chris.
On purpose?
Or what?
On purpose? I might have drawn through there. I don't know.
Miggy did, and now look at him. He's sick.
He says he's sick, but I think he got the old Callahan justice. You know what I mean? Like that.
If he was going through there playing Garth Brooks, he might have got some looks. I told him he had to switch that over to Hank Williams.
So listen, they don't like Garth Brooks? What's up with that? Because Garth Brooks is like country and also like rock and roll.
Garth Brooks to me was, now granted, I did go to his concert. He put on an amazing show. Okay, amazing show. But to me.
Why I'm not shocked that you were at one of his concerts.
Hey, believe it or not, look, I've been to a Megadeth concert. I've been to.
With Garth Brooks opening for
you? No, I've been to.
Limp Bizkit?
No. Yeah. I've been to. MC Hammer. Actually, my dad.
How old were you?
Oh, I was young. But my dad.
Did he have the pants?
Huh?
He had the pants.
Oh, when has MC Hammer not had the pants? That's what made MC
Hammer.
My
kids asked me that.
Oh, when he was doing, what is it, Bumps in a Humps? And he was wearing that little thong?
Oh, that like wrestling singlet thing?
It wasn't a wrestling singlet. It was like a Speedo.
Oh, it was horrible.
But it looked like a thong. It's like, bro, we can see your junk. Put it away.
Yeah.
Is that the point of a thong?
I don't know.
I didn't want to see
Never wore one.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I do.
Do you?
That's all I wear.
On the rig?
That's all I wear, bro.
Is that what's underneath the fight shorts?
When we're right. I don't want to picture this.
Just remember that anytime you see me at OP.
You got a thong on?
I got a thong on.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I'm going to start saying that every time I roll with Miggy. I'll be like, hey,
you got a thong. So while I was like, hey, all right, man, let's get a roll. And I'm like, no.
What?
Why don't you roll with me? I was like, it's an inside joke.
Listen. He's going to start playing the harp.
The thong is under the shorts. It's not like you can see it.
Yeah, but I know.
Yeah, but the visual is there now.
I guess I'm not going to be rolling with anybody then.
You just need the spats that are a little bit see-through.
Yeah, like the women's.
That's how that works. Yeah, the women's. I have to tell you guys to stop doing
Gotta
all
do the squat test, girls.
Yeah.
Squat
Please
test.
Please look in the mirror test. And squat test.
Yeah, we don't want to see your monkey.
Huh? What?
All right, Coco.
You've seen women, you know, grappling with those see-through spots.
No, no, I don't.
Oh, my God.
That's how my eyes go. I divert my eyes.
It's you got polka dots today.
Listen.
Oh, my God.
You need to wear different type of spats. I could see all of it. Listen, and while...
Yeah, leggings are not spats.
Yeah, and while some of it might look nice, it's like, I'm here to grapple. I'm not here to look at your cooch. No offense.
Said your cooch.
Yeah. Is that not a
thing? No, I think it's funny.
Oh, okay.
I think it's funny, man. Say cooch again.
Yeah, cooch.
Say get all up in that cooch.
Get up in that cooch.
You know what that almost sounds like? Gooch.
No.
You know what the gooch is? The cooch and the gooch. He said it's a space.
I've known guys.
It's called the perineum.
Yeah. I've known guys that have got it pierced.
What? Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. How the fuck?
Yep.
Who would do such a thing?
Gay guys.
No. I mean, who would actually do that for
you? Like, I don't know if you'd want to get pierced there, man, because what if you have a messy day, you know? And then, like, it gets all up in there, and then you get some infections and some shit going on. And
it happens.
I'm a sympathetic puker.
Did anybody watch the fights last night?
I watched all the way up to, I think I was like two fights out from the main event. I couldn't keep my eyes open. I had a busy day yesterday.
I started to watch and I kind of dozed off and woke up for the main event.
Oh, that's good.
So I got to see Brian Ortega and Cobb Swanson go at it. That was pretty fun, man. Ortega was on fire. Well, he's on fire. He's 13-0 now.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see the submission attempt in the first round?
I didn't see the attempt, no. All I saw was the highlight this morning of him. It looked like it started as kind of a standing guillotine, and then it went down.
I didn't see any of that, man. Well, you know, I attempted to watch it, but there's like a party going on and beer and dogs and shit, and I did a thing, guys.
You did a thing?
I actually saw you do something yesterday that I have never seen you do.
Yeah, what was that?
You actually went dark.
What do you mean I went dark?
You went
for a couple hours, yeah.
Yeah, you went social media dark for a couple hours.
I warned you guys, though. I was like, listen.
Yeah, I know, but listen, guys, I've never seen it.
I got to do some shit till 3.
I've just never seen that normally.
Leave a message. I'll get back to you as soon as I can afterwards.
It's amazing that he can go dark on a Saturday, but we cannot get him to put his phone down on a Sunday when he's trying to be engaged on a podcast.
Listen, man, I am engaged, man. I'm engaged on this podcast. I go rage on this podcast.
Because you guys can't see that, we're all looking at it.
Yeah.
Like, what
I get hate in the
about?
Podcast.
I wish I had a dollar for every time we've said something to Art, and then you just hear that silence for, you know, like, 5 seconds. We're
looking at him.
Yeah. Processing.
Yeah.
I'm like, how do I don't want to react to this, man? Do I go simple or hit him with layers? Sometimes got to hit him with layers.
I'd go for the onion.
Go for the onion. God. Give him some stinky shit at the end, right? Yeah.
Make him cry.
Speaking of, man, I don't know about the poster. I don't, I'm not really into wrestling.
If you want to do a poster,
we need to keep the rock and roll, man.
If you want to do a poster, you're
I like the Marvel one.
No,
like the Street Fighter one was good. The rock and roll one is dopest. The wrestling one, I was like, I don't know, man. Wrestling.
Let me ask you. Do you want to do a poster?
Not really.
Okay.
But I don't.
Then why don't you draw?
I'm giving you, man. I'll fucking draw you. I'm gonna draw you, man. You're gonna love this shit.
You can do whatever you want, bro.
This is gonna
he's gonna do this instead of
this. This is all I'm saying.
You done messed up now, AA Ron.
All I'm saying is, if I'm doing the poster,
hold on, I got you.
I'm doing the poster.
You hold real still.
Listen, I even made you the champ.
Was I the champ?
Yeah.
Oh, I like the poster now.
Yeah, see?
He didn't even look.
Since Wally was the only one that really watched it, did you see Benito's fight?
With
Benito's.
Who's Benito?
He was with Jason Knight.
Yeah.
The jiu-jitsu redneck. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It was a pretty good fight.
That was pretty decent, yeah.
It was.
I'm sure.
It got a little ugly there towards the end. They started gassing out and getting tired. It got a little flaily. Yeah. But it was still a good fight.
Yeah, it was pretty decent, man.
Dude, you get so tired in MMA fights, bro. You don't even understand. Like, those guys that go for fucking 15, 20 minutes, like, straight, fucking good on you. God damn, man. You know what? This masterpiece that I'm doing right here, man, is looking sexy as fuck, bro.
It's like a stick figure, people.
No, it's not a stick figure. I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you what it is, man.
He just keeps whipping his head. That's, like, all I see is whipping his head.
And I guess, what was it? Trayvon?
Martin?
No, Gillis.
Yeah, I was like, whoa, back it up there, no, Callahan.
Trayvon Gillis.
I guess that one.
That was a fight. It was pretty good. Because that one there towards the end, it was just, he was just landing a left jab, right overhand. Just, it was there every single time he went for it. So,
I normally go to bed around 10, so.
That's when the flame started kind of crashing on me. It was about 10, 10:30.
So, I think around 10:30, I fell asleep, but I did watch that Benitez-Jason Knight fight.
I think you're going to like this picture I'm doing of you, buddy.
Sure.
Because you're going to look jacked. To the kills.
I'll probably go back because reading it, this, Andre, I'm not even going to even attempt. Broke the rule.
Who's fucking
here we go. Hold on.
Oh, it's calling in.
Hey, what's up? Who is this?
Hello?
Who's this?
This is Brandon.
Brandon.
Hey, what's up, Brandon?
What is up, dude? How you doing?
What's up, man? Doing good?
Just chilling.
Just chilling. So we got Brandon. Brandon owns tobacco farms. And
dispensaries.
And not dispensaries, tobacco farms.
And I'm actually trying to get into plastic so that I can create large industrial-sized penises.
Oh.
You should probably get into Bitcoin.
You should probably get into, maybe latex and rubber and...
And Bitcoin. Yeah, for sure.
Bitcoin.
I'll call it Dickcoin.
Hey, so I wanted to talk to you about the match yesterday. I wanted to get Squirrel in here because Squirrel wanted to have some thoughts about that too. The Calterra fight with Marcelo Cohen. Did you see it?
Yeah, it was kind of funny because I was actually on the phone with Calterra right before the fight.
Oh, nice. And what did you tell him to do? You coached him through it?
Yeah. But there was none of that going on. There wasn't a whole coaching on my part. This is kind of how the whole thing went. We were talking about his plane tickets. He just got his purchase list and everything for his plane tickets. And then we were talking about where he was going to be staying and stuff when he comes here for the seminar in Jacksonville.
Well, when is the seminar?
The seminar is January 6th and 7th. The 6th is going to be Gi. And then for all you 10th Planet people out there, I decided to do a day especially for you just because, you know, nothing but love.
Okay. And that'll be
on Sunday the 7th.
And how can people, pre-register for the seminar?
They can go on to knuckleupfl@yahoo and do it through PayPal.
Okay.
Or if they want to, you know, come by the school, we're located over off of San Jose Boulevard in the right across from Target and Publix. They can come by there and pay, or they can mail a check directly to us if they wanted to do it like that.
You're taking checks, bro? You're so brave.
I know, right? I'd be scared that one of them checks is going to bounce.
All right, listen, so man.
Let's do this.
Hit them up on PayPal. It's easy. Yeah. You can go to PayPal and you get one.
Do PayPal or cash.
I prefer, or they can pay cash if they want. I have had a couple people that actually came to the school and paid cash.
Nice.
What we're doing is we're putting them on a spreadsheet, and whenever you guys show up.
Mark them off.
Anybody that, huh?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah. What we're doing is, especially because we got a lot of people from Miami and Orlando and Tampa and everywhere like that coming. And I don't, some of these people I actually don't even know. So we're just, we have the spreadsheet list and you show up, show your license. Boom. There you are. You're on the list. Good to go.
Cool. So that is going to be again, what date?
The GI seminar is going to be January the 6th from 10 to 1. And then the Noki seminar is going to be January the 7th from 10 to 1 also.
And listen, how many spots you're allowing? How many spots are left to open?
As of right now, we actually had a huge influx of people the very last minute because we did a discount. The discount actually ended yesterday. So we're at about 75% capacity right now.
How many more? How many more do you have open? So that way,
somewhere in the range of about 18 to 19 more spots.
That's it, guys. 18 to 19 spots. Snatch them up quick because I'll tell you, I've held seminars and we've held seminars, Brian Brown and I. And, you know, once it hits that 18 mark, it goes quick. And then people are like trying to scramble to get in that last minute stuff. It doesn't work. Once capacity is met, we can't let you in. You can't do it. Like legally, you can't.
Once it's done, it's done.
Exactly. Done is done. There's only a certain amount of mat room.
Our square footage for our gym only allows us to have 65 people on those mats at a time. And obviously, you can't really move around a whole lot tight with that many people on the mat. So the seminar, to keep it fair for everybody, you guys are paying for a seminar that you're going to be able to get the best out of. I'm not going to sit there and crowd that place in where you can't even move. So I'm, for the all the people that are paying for it and everything like that, I think it's only fair that we limit it to no more than 50 people a day. That way you can, still be able to work the moves, maybe a little bit of grappling at the end, and really enjoy yourself. And you're not shoved up somebody's ass because there's too many people in there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure.
Dig it, man. Dig it.
So going back to his match with Marcelo Cohen, tell me a little bit about it, because unfortunately, I did not see it. All I saw was the article that said that he basically put on a clinic.
He did. He did. I was on the phone with him, and he ended up – he just put the phone down, and he's like, I'll talk to you when I get done. So he literally left the phone on in the locker room, and I was watching it on Flow Grappling. So I could hear on my phone people talking in the locker room. Then I watched him walk out, and I'm like, what the fuck is going on? And sure enough, he got off the mat and he walked right back there and picked up the phone. He's like, yeah, so this is the days I'm gonna be here. I was like, wow, I'm glad this was so difficult for you. But yeah, when he went into the match, I mean, nothing against Cohen. He's legit practitioner, but
what you're saying is there's levels of this shit, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This was one of the probably he looked like a cat playing with a mouse.
Man, like a bear mauling a small child, right?
I mean, yeah, exactly. It was a bear mauling a small child, exactly. But Kaio came in there. He didn't do anything crazy, no nasty, ridiculous takedown. He came in, he pulled guard, and immediately the pass to full mount. You can sit there and watch it 100 times, and it was like a magician. He just ended up in mount. I don't know how he did. I've watched it from every angle as possible, and I just don't know what happened.
Wow.
It was wizardry.
Straight wizardry.
So.
Well, we're not really, really big fans of the other guy anyway, but, that's a story for another day.
That's the guy that was here in Jacksonville.
Yeah. He was, he did a expert division at Naga and like beat a blue belt. And he was like, yeah, you shouldn't be becoming an expert, man, expecting to win, getting all salty, which the guy wasn't being salty. But a lot of that too, I think, is jiu-jitsu times, man. They made it more sensational than what it really was.
Yeah. So, yeah, Kyle pretty much like a little ball of yarn.
Well, cool.
And I think more, he was probably thinking what he was going to eat for dinner more than he was worried about.
He's like, man, I'm going to be down in Florida. You know, those fuckers got some good sweet tea. He probably doesn't sound like that at all.
Yeah.
He doesn't sound like that at all.
But the funny thing is he left the mat and it changes the view on the TV and just walked off the mat. And the next thing I know, he's on the freaking phone again. And he's, yeah, we're going to be flying in at this time, blah, 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 and this and that. So I was like, did you just grapple? Or, I mean, did you just freaking, you know, what was going on?
How long was the match?
Not long, because this video is only 6 minutes.
So less than 6 minutes. Very nice. I like it. You know, I like the fact that he's cool with 10 Planet people, because he hangs out with Danny.
Oh, yeah, he's definitely cool with 10 Planet. I mean, matter of fact, you know, he's a big IBJJF world champion and stuff, but guess what? He beat him with a heel hook.
Oh, nice.
So, I mean, it just goes to show you, man, you can do it all. I mean, you can do IBJJF, you can do EBIs, you can fight to win. Don't limit yourself. Don't limit yourself at all.
I agree.
And I'm pretty sure that Kai is actually going to be showing some leg stuff on the Nogi Day. He was talking about it. So I'm looking real forward to that. I can't wait to go out there with some of my 10th Planet brothers and get schooled.
It's going to be good times, man. I'm sorry, but I'm going to get
Mugashamanisamukunatashamehanamoha. He just fucked up. He wasn't really saying anything.
Somewhere in there's an inside joke.
Yeah, I know. He's been saying inside jokes that he only knows.
Well,
we all get lost. We're like, what?
Listen, there's three inside jokes kicked out there, right? It's not my fault. You're not on the know. Well,
why are you saying inside jokes?
You guys are actually in on the know on one of them.
Well, damn it. Sorry, I got guys, excited. Again, there's 18 spots, maybe 19 left, so don't wait.
Hey, what's the PayPal? What's the PayPal?
Yeah.
What was that again?
PayPal email address.
It's knuckleupfl, all one word, at yahoo.com.
All right, knuckleupfl@yahoo.com.
Knuckleupfl@yahoo.com.
What's FL for?
For Florida.
Oh. Well, that makes sense. Knuckle up.
We're trying to help you out here and Art's messing it up.
Sorry, guys. Knuckled up. Knuckled up FL. All right. Yahoo.com.
Knuckled up FL. Yes, Art.
Got it.
All right, bro. Well, thank you for calling and for plugging in the seminar. And guys, again.
No problem, bro.
18 spots left. Don't miss out. Thanks, Brandon. We appreciate it, brother.
Later, brother.
Later.
So you guys are making fun of me for saying that over three times, but motherfuckers don't know it unless you say it a minimum three times. You go to any commercial, it's three times, three times, three times is a magic number. Sometimes you have to hit it four times, four times. How many times?
Three.
Times. Minimum three times, sometimes four times for it to get in the head, man. I know what I'm doing. I'm a fucking coach.
Yeah, well, you said knuckle up at yahoo.com. It's
I said knuckle up what?
FL.
What's the Florida for? FL for Florida. Boom. Now you told a story. Now you understand why it's knuckleupfl.com.
Okay.
Y'all ready for some breaking news?
Oh, sure. What's going on?
Gary Tonin has officially retired from competitive grappling.
No, what? He hasn't. He's got to go against Gio first.
Nope.
Is he trolling again?
No, he just announced that he is not taking any more competitive matches until after his first MMA fight.
Oh, that is true.
So he's not retired.
He's not retired. Get out of here.
He's not retiring.
What clickbait did you look that up on?
It was probably on Import Sports or some shit like that.
Fucking, what's it called?
That's hardly retiring.
It's not retiring.
That's just putting it aside for a little bit. Thanks for the fake news, Chris. Wait, Ravishing Chris Rude?
I had to laugh because the Instagram page I was following, they were, you know, he's retiring, you know. Gary Tonin retires from competitive BJJ, will now pursue an MMA career. That was their headline. So I had to read it. I was like, what? And then if you go to his page, he explains it, that he's just done until he's after his first MMA fight.
You didn't even bring up GSP yet.
Well, that's right.
He vacated his.
Yeah, he's going to vacate the 185.
Yeah, smart. Good. Come in, win. Boom, you're still on top, dog. Get down.
But
yeah.
Doesn't he have some kind of a.
It's colitis. He has the itis.
Colitis?
Yeah,
colon?
I think we may have brought it
up last
week.
Yeah, we
did bring
it up last week.
But it was, I thought, officially noted this week that he was actually...
But it was put out there. You know, it was alleged.
Yeah.
You know.
It's so weird that these guys have colitis. Like, what's the cause of colitis? Let's look this shit up.
Steroids.
It can be anything.
Well, you just look at Chris. Steroids. Steroids. Most definitely, it's the aliens.
He's probably snorting that muscle farm.
Yeah. Listen, it had to do with my colitis. It's my aliens.
If I get colitis from that, I'll still do it.
What, the aliens?
If I get the Gordon Ryan muscle farmish.
Oh, I'll be snorting lines. I don't give a shit.
I just bought a tub of the muscle farm.
Did you?
Yeah.
Is it the muscle?
Does it come with its own 12-pack of abs?
Yeah, it does, and it comes also with a mirror. And a nice. And a credit card for you to cut it.
Nice.
Do you like credit cards?
Does it come with the injections or no?
No, you snort
it. You snort it. Well, I mean, then you don't want abs like Gordon Ryan.
No, obviously not.
I mean, that guy, his abs have got abs.
Yeah.
He does have an insane amount of abs.
He does.
It's not even human.
No, there's like 8 of them down there. And it's like, well, you got some extra muscles in your core, bro.
Man, I told you guys how you get those last two done, right?
Yeah, no, why don't you tell
please.
Us? Go ahead.
No, I've already told you. First. I've already told you guys.
I've completely forgotten. Please tell me.
Well, when you're in the shower.
Should I leave now?
What you do is you get yourself a rag, wash rag, right? You know, maybe a couple of them. I don't know how strong you are at that point. But you got to work with at least one. Get that thing soaking wet. You're hanging over your dealio. You know what I mean?
Over your what, sir?
Dealio. You
know? Are you doing push-ups?
It's like a cockroach, but it's not. You're doing lifts. You're doing
That's
lifts.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, I wasn't going to say
you're
that.
You're doing D-curls. We're going to call those D-curls. You got to do D-curls. You put the rag over it, and you do D-curls. Now, listen.
Three sets of 12.
No. You don't go three sets of 12. You know when you start counting? When it starts burning. When it starts burning, that's when you start counting. Then try to hit 12.
So you're supposed to go to the doctor when it starts burning.
I was just going to say
that. Well, that's a little bit different kind of burning that I'm talking about. That right there.
Don't take your Bulgarian back home.
Inside, outside. Hey man, I'm just saying.
Hey, if you can do a D-curl.
You've already lifted my Bulgarian bag.
If you could do a D-curl with the Bulgarian bag, I actually want to see that.
Well.
I do a little bit of weight.
Well, there's loops on that thing for a reason.
What about the Kegel balls?
Listen, the Kegel ball is more of an energy deal.
Jesus. Okay. Why did you go there?
Now you're talking about like Tai Jitsu versus Jin Jitsu, right?
Oh God.
Tai Jitsu is a physical form, and then Jin Jitsu is the mental form. Okay. If I hit you some Jin Jitsu, okay. Now, if you don't know where Naruto Shippuden is, you're not going to understand. So what you got to do is watch about 1,000 episodes of Naruto. It explains it all.
That'll get you through season 3.
That'll get you through Naruto, and then the second series, Naruto Shippuden, when they're a little bit older. But it explains it all. It really does. So, kind of the same thing. So, basically, it's like Taijutsu for the D. You'd be like Rock Lee with weights. Take those things off. Amazing. You're amazing. All the control in the world. It's great.
You know, I feel like they kind of ripped off the whole Dragon Ball Z with Rock Lee with the weight thing. Goku did that originally.
No, man. They went to a fake little mini planet with high gravity zones. This doesn't even make sense.
And he also, his boots and everything else were weighted.
Whatever, dude. That's a training method. Like, come on, get out of here, man. Like, you have to figure out some other training method. How do we make this weighted?
Yeah, but it was before Naruto. Dragon Ball Z was.
Yeah, but it's like a cheesy version of Naruto.
Oh, get up. All right.
I'm going to get all these Dragon Balls and make wishes because my guys keep dying. Mm-hmm. Oh, time to go collect the Dragon Balls again.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So boring.
Mm-hmm. I know. Mm-hmm. Talking about Naruto and Shuruto and
Shippuden. But anyways,
and
what I'm saying is like you got something with a very shallow storyline and depth and character versus something that's very deep and a lot of detail in characters. Even
it's a fucking cartoon. How deep characters. Can it be?
Listen,
it
could be amazing. It has nothing to do with cartoons. It's actually a novel. But the novel got turned into a cartoon. But the cartoon is actually like a Japan.
It actually wasn't a novel. It was a manga.
Well, a manga is a novel.
No, a manga is a comic.
Novel.
Okay.
So tomato, tomato. Who gives a fuck?
Okay. It's actually a manga. Man, what you know about mangas, man? Over in Callahan, that's what we do. Matter of fact, that's how I learned how to read was the fucking mangas, man.
Damn right, you start right to left.
God damn right, man. You start right to left. We do everything backwards. Those Japanese are fucking genius.
Still got some of them up there in my closet.
Yeah. I got a couple other things in my closet, too, man. We're just gonna keep those things
there. There's a lot of things that should stay in the closet, your sexuality being one of them.
Hey-oh. Oh. That was for Miggy. Was that an inside joke?
Yes.
Not anymore.
But you got it, so.
Yeah, not is anymore.
It, but you're outside right now.
Guys, that right there was an inside joke that got out. It just left the closet. Oh, double meanings.
All right. Sorry about that, guys. Hey, did you guys see that it was reported that Conor McGregor was going to fight Manny Pacquiao?
Yeah.
Yeah, Dana White came out and said, "And that shit ain't true. Fuck Bob Arum. Stop putting rumors out there like that."
Bob Arum. That guy, isn't he racist?
He might be.
Is white people?
Yeah.
I'm sure.
Aren't all white people racist anyway?
Just white people?
I think he's from Callahan, though.
Makes sense.
He must be racist.
Makes sense. He just don't like nobody. He's like, listen, man, you can't make money off of white people.
He said that jujitsu was for homosexuals.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Homosexuals. Go tell a bunch of Brazilians.
Guilty!
Guilty! Like, you know, the guys that say that, man, they're so brave, man. They're so brave because
they're old.
No. Listen, they're in a time and age right now where you just can't, like, throttle them. You know what I mean? You're not allowed to because we have to worry about, like, going to jail for murder, assault and battery, whatever. But they would never say that. Drop them off in Brazil. Go say that to one of these Brazilian cats in their gym. Tell them, hey, what you do is gay. Go ahead, do it, motherfucker. Dare you. I double dog dare you.
Get hit with a boomerang.
You get hit with a boomerang. And then
wait, no. You're going to get hit with the bag that the boomerang was in.
Shit.
Just happened. And then you're going to claim that you got hit with a boomerang.
I got hit with a boomerang. I don't know, man.
Sissy boy. But anyway,
I do know is
I don't want to see that match, to be honest with you.
Nah, nobody does.
Really?
Who wants to see it?
No.
Why would you want to see it?
Because Manny Pacquiao doesn't have the oomph anymore to sell that fight.
I'm not even interested.
I'd rather see Conor McGregor against Paulie Maginoli.
You know, honestly, I don't even think. I think the cherry's been popped on the whole boxing with McGregor.
Yeah. No, man. You know what I think? I think Conor needs to fight our boy Tony Ferguson. That's what needs to happen.
He's not going to fight him.
Fight him.
He's not.
Fight him.
It doesn't even seem like Conor's going to fight anytime soon, period.
He's just...
Fight him.
He's having
Except
fun.
Except for in the Irish pubs.
Ooh, yeah. Irish pubs. I mean, you got the hitmans after him. So he might be pulling some sort of Jason Statham type stuff, man. You better get some other skills in there. Shooting skills. Nunchuck skills.
Dodging skills.
Driving skills.
Bulletproof major skills.
Bitches love skills.
Nah, he's just got money. They'll just fly down, pay off.
Moving to America skills.
He's going to need to make another fight, make another
100
million. They only wanted $900,000. So make a million, a little bit, and you save your life a little bit.
The gangsters wanted $900,000?
Yeah, that was the hit.
Oh, they got a hit on him?
Yep. Supposedly, it was reported that was the price of the hit.
Who knows, man?
Supposedly, he also took a jet, flew down, and paid it off.
Oh.
Paid off the $900,000.
Yeah.
Interesting.
That's what I would do.
He paid $30,000 and just called it even.
Was it Daddy Dana's jet?
He came over and said, listen, you're going to take these $30,000 and take it and leave it.
Why you sound Scottish?
I don't know.
Dude, that was Snatch all the way. That was freaking Brad Pitt.
No, listen, man, he went $30,000.
You like dags?
You like dags?
Weren't they Scottish?
I like dags. No, man.
No.
Irish.
No, they were Irish.
I thought they were Scottish.
Gypsies.
Well, he sounds Scottish.
Travelers. I'm sorry. You shouldn't say gypsy either. Travelers.
No, why can't you say gypsies?
Why can't you call them gypsies?
It's one of the whole
cultures.
Pretty
sure it's gypsies.
It is gypsies, but it's the whole, you know, triggered and offending people by calling them gypsies.
Do they get triggered over it?
I don't know any.
I thought that they didn't give a fuck.
Even though there is actually a pretty big concentration of them here in Florida and in Georgia.
Is there?
Yes, there is.
Is there really?
Are those the guys that drive the gypsy cabs?
I don't know. Because the whole reason why I know that is because I was watching the whole Amanda was watching. Oh, shit.
Oh, here we go. Let's see.
Who that? Oh, Robbie.
Thank you for calling Locker Room Talk. Who do we have on the line?
How you got Roberto Nunez? How y'all doing?
Oh, shit. He went Callahan on you. Roberto Nunez.
I don't know. I thought that would be a little more Mexican.
Yeah, me and Chris, we brothers and cousins, you know?
There we go.
Brothers and cousins.
And cousins. We all family.
You know,
same
whichever stump. One you want, depends on who we hang around the family, you know what I mean?
What's up, brother?
So
how you doing?
What you got to talk about?
Well,
doing good, man. Doing good.
Did you
about
see?
To go take some Christmas pictures.
Did you see the post?
I saw it, and I already forgot what it was about, though.
Okay.
Chris.
What?
Well, why did I say Chris?
Yeah, I don't know.
I meant Robbie. Robbie.
Answer him, please.
I got a question for you, buddy. Did you set up your account yet?
Ah, here we go.
Robbie, I'm talking to you.
Robbie, he's become the Bitcoin expert Art has, so you just need to...
Have you set your account up yet?
Yeah, baby. I got my account set up. I'm making money.
Good. That's what I'm talking about. What's that? Hey, so... Real quick, what'd you buy?
What did I buy?
Yeah.
I bought a certain amount of Bitcoin. I don't want to tell people how rich I am. But a little bit of Bitcoin, a little bit of Litecoin so far.
I bought some Litecoin too.
And I'm excited, man. just definitely want to make some moves before I potentially miss out. So just trying to make the right moves to make a little money. And if I lose out, you know, because maybe it's a bad investment, well, it's not going to be too much. But if it's a great investment, well, who knows?
Listen, so, man, we're up $790 since yesterday.
Exactly.
So I'm saying.
Yeah, anything 10%, 10% gain is a win always. So.
And you know the amazing thing is about that, Chris, what? Is that 10% win is taking a month or 3 months. It's taken a couple hours sometimes at this point with Bitcoin.
Yeah. The only thing that a lot of people worry about with the Bitcoin, though, is the volatility. So, yeah, you can get that gain
absolutely.
In a few hours, and then you can also get that loss in a couple hours. So that's why I think a lot of people have kind of stayed away from it. They've stayed to those more traditional stocks and bonds and things like that. But
of course.
I don't know. Art's kind of getting me a little more into the Litecoin thing. I think I'm gonna have to move some stuff around.
That one's grown quite a bit in the past month or whatnot. It's probably grown.
It went from $3 to $158. Yeah.
Yeah, I was surprised. I looked at that and I said, "Let me hop on that." So I bought a little bit of that as well, and just you know, trying to see what happens. Put a little towards it, you know, nothing to where I go
excuse
broke
me.
Trying
I'm
to
at
do it, but
148.
It's smart moves.
Yeah, it's good, man. Jump on that shit.
Heck yeah.
Get on it. Get down on it. It's going up right now, man, because everybody's talking about it. Get it in while you can.
After this podcast, it's going to go up like 20%.
Yeah, because everybody listens to us. Yeah, yeah. If you need some financial counseling, you know, tune into Locker Room Talk because we're going to take care of you. Pump it up.
So while we were talking about Conor McGregor and Manny Pacquiao before we got your call, they were supposed to be okay. They were supposed to be fighting, but Dana put a halt to all the rumors and saying
put a hit on that.
Yeah, it's like that's not happening.
So it was just a rumor. It's not real.
Yeah, it was just a rumor. It's not happening. I don't want to see that shit.
I
wouldn't
mind seeing that fight. I don't really care about him, Paulie. You know,
actually,
I definitely wouldn't mind.
Actually, I wouldn't mind seeing Paulie and Conor instead of Conor and Manny Pacquiao. No offense to Manny, but
I guess because of the drama that built up, it would be nice to kind of see, you know, they talk
right.
a lot of crap. And
exactly.
But, you know, yeah, I mean, I guess on one part, too, I also want to kind of see another legend that, you know, Conor could fight that wouldn't just outpoint him. Well, he did not point him, but, you know, Floyd Mayweather did a good job, of course. But someone that would come out in that first round and we could really see what's up. But, I mean, I guess he gets that with Paulie as well. So,
well, the word was
either or, I wouldn't mind watching him. With another, at least one more boxing match, but it might even be exciting to perhaps get back in the UFC once or twice. But when you're making $50 to $150 million to fight for maximum 36 minutes, not a bad trade-off.
No, that's a lot of Bitcoin that you get by.
Real question. What's the difference between the Ethereum app? Why are they telling you to buy that, the app versus the app that we got, the Coinbase? Why were you told to buy the Ethereum app versus the Coinbase?
I have no idea. That's why I was asking your friend there.
Well, who's telling you this shit? Because they should give you a little backup on that, I think, maybe.
I don't want to call them out on the podcast.
Okay, they didn't tell you.
It was Wallace. Just kidding.
God damn it, Wallace.
Yeah, with all my Bitcoin knowledge that I have.
No, it was just a buddy of mine. Honestly, he was just trying to tell me. He told me to download both. And I was like, well, what is one... what you can make purchases with maybe the Bitcoin, and the other one is how you buy more Bitcoin and sell it. Like that's what I'm guessing with it, but
check it out. So the one that we have right there, Coinbase, you can buy and sell on the one app. So I don't get why you have to, and you got Ethereum too. So Wallow's over here like a little fucking kid snoring and shit. We're talking about adult stuff over here. You know, make-believe money and stuff.
Make-believe money.
Basically. Make-believe money, man.
There's one company for the Bitcoin that kind of turns into a multi-level marketing thing where you like...
It's a pyramid scam.
It is. Because you have to like get a sponsor and then you start sponsoring people and you get part of their money and then like
I don't know. We're not talking about that.
No, that's what the guy at work does. So he was talking about
that's what
like,
he does. He was trying to get you. He was trying to sneak you in, huh?
Did you guys listen to the newest MMA show that Joe Rogan did?
No,
which one? The one with the big kicking?
Justin Wren?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, so something interesting on there. I don't know the everything that happened beforehand, but apparently I don't know if they like donated a certain amount of Bitcoin some a while back because apparently
he was
does like a lot of work.
Yeah, he did it. I think it was a year and a half ago, and he's worth $50,000 today.
Yeah,
exactly, like 50 to 60,000 or something.
65. I'm sorry.
I don't know how much.
He did.
Exactly.
Jamie Vernon corrected him, saying that it's 65.
Nice.
Yeah, I heard
absolutely.
It.
They're like, you know, who knows how much it was? Who knows? Just a couple that year and a half ago, maybe it's 3 or 4. I don't know.
So not only did Joe Rogan take that Bitcoin, and basically what he did is he took 50 grand and gave it to the charity.
Yeah, Fight for the Forgotten.
Right. Exactly. And now that the Bitcoin has made that much money, he's going to take all that money and give it back to the charity too.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Yeah, because he was matching whatever was donated. Rogan said he was going to match as well up to a certain point. So I think it was 50.
So my props to Joe Rogan for giving that much money.
Yeah, so that'll go to Fight for the Forgotten and Water 4.
Yeah.
He's got that FU money.
Yeah, for sure. Art's going to have FU money in about 6 hours.
baller over there.
And he's going to be like, you know what? I don't need these podcasts anymore. I'm done. I got my
You're
money.
Like, where did Art go? Like, I don't know.
He's on his boat.
He went back to Alaska.
Yeah, that's where I'm going.
You got the island in the Caribbean.
That's where I'm going. Good. Alaska.
Well, cool.
When was the last time you went to Alaska, Art?
Too long ago.
He's not paying attention. He's doodling.
He says too long ago. You didn't listen?
Is he texting?
No, no. He's doodling on a piece of paper.
Yeah.
I'm doodling.
Well, what else you guys got going on?
We're doing a podcast.
Oh, I figured that.
Well, we have a Kaya Terra seminar going on the 9th. Nogi, if you want to do some of that or whatever, you got to hit up knuckleduplfl.com. I mean, at yahoo.com. And you can get yours. I'll be there.
He's not really into it right now.
Totally.
I don't even know what he just said.
I'm all in. Yeah. I'm all into it.
Sorry, man. It's like hurting cats.
If you're watching, you can see him doodling.
Hi.
Did you watch any of the fights last night, Robbie?
What was that?
Did you watch any of the fights last night on the UFC?
I did not. I was actually in Surprise, Disney yesterday, so I was traveling back at that time. So
nice. Which part did you hit?
Well, you know what, Robbie? I had a couple hours, so I called you yesterday, and that's how I found out you're in Disney. You know what I mean? And
yes,
you know, I was pretty happy that you picked up the phone. That's pretty cool, man. It's good. It's good on you, man. Even though you're in the most magical place on the earth, you had enough time to actually answer the phone.
Now, were you camping or were you RVing?
It's pretty cool.
He's being facetious.
Yeah. Yes.
No, I was not camping. I didn't have my $200,000 trailer sitting in a parking lot.
Oh, okay. Just
or whatever
checking.
It is.
Hey, it only cost me 2 Bitcoin.
No. Okay. No. No camping, but definitely had a good time. Drove down there in the morning, drove back.
What park did you hit, Robbie?
Had a good time. The kids loved it, so it was a good time.
Did you do Disney, or did you do one of the other parks?
No, it was the Magic Kingdom.
Okay, sweet.
Hey, listen, man, that shit, I hear that shit's magical.
Wow.
Art, we're going to get you.
Is it Art,
whenever your Bitcoin doubles, you'll be able to afford to go down there.
I can't afford it.
I'm telling you, seriously, Robbie, I think it's almost getting to the point where we need to do a GoFundMe page for Art so we can just take him down to Disney.
I was considering
Listen, it. Man, I ain't down to be happy and shit.
We still haven't gone to Pandora. So.
Yeah, we need to go to Pandora first.
Well, that's Animal Kingdom.
Why you got to go to Pandora when you could just pull it up on your
Listen,
phone?
Man, because they'll eat your eyes like juju bees.
Have you been to Animal Kingdom yet, Robbie? To the Pandora part?
Oh, yeah, I love Animal Kingdom. That was really cool.
Yeah.
I always feel like it's a little bit too close to crocodiles when you're doing that one tour. I don't know.
Yeah, the behind-the-scenes one. That is,
yeah,
but
like,
it's awesome.
That doesn't feel too safe.
The one where the kids got eaten?
Cool.
No, they have a behind-the-scenes. They have a behind-the-scenes thing where you can basically they take you behind all the exhibits and everything, and one of the parts you go across it's supposed to look like a dilapidated wooden bridge. But you're but you're clipped in and all like that. So even if something were to happen, you're only going to fall 3 feet
into the crocodile's mouth.
But yeah, but the bridge goes over the crocodile pit and all like that. And then they also go and they take you up to the hippos and they feed a hippo just a few feet away from you.
What do you feed them? Watermelon?
They do. They toss watermelon or lettuce, you know.
Kids.
Young no,
kids.
Not kids. But it's actually really cool. Me and Amanda did it a long time ago.
We used to have kids at the same time. Get out of my head.
It's the two people like, without kids that want to know me.
We're actually, we've got to wait two more years before Tyler's old enough to where to he can go.
And I was just going to say
he can go and do it. Would y'all quit trying to toss my goddamn kids into the fucking hippo pit?
You're like, listen, man, we would toss them in now, but that's not barely a snack.
He'll be able to run. It's all right.
Now, you shave hair. I don't have kids. I don't care to have kids, so I don't want to go to the animal kingdom or none of that shit. Well, there's like 50, 100, million, trillion, billion kids running around.
I like Animal Kingdom more than Magic now.
They're both good, but honestly, I think for art, we need to take them to Epcot, and then we just do like the pub. We do the around the world pub crawl thing
at Epcot. I just want to ride the rides.
Well, I mean, there's a few rides. Soarin' is pretty cool.
Listen, just show him a picture of Epcot and give him, you know, a Four Loko, and he'll be all right.
Nah, bro, you gotta go and get that stuff. You gotta go get some sake, then you can go over to Germany and have some German beer.
He wants to give you some sake? Sake?
Oh, jeez.
See, that's that one-layer joke that just doesn't hit like a multi-layer joke does. You see what I'm saying? You gotta set the shit up. You see that, man? He wants to give you sake. You know sake? You get it, sake? He wants to give that to you. He wants you to have that first.
Well, There is since me and Robbie both visit Disney quite a lot. Did you just hear about the biggest, the big dark cloud that just came over Disney?
No.
They just busted a pedophile ring out of Disney. Just busted 27.
Mickey's getting a little hands on.
Yeah. 27 people that work in the Disney parks. they busted for child porn and stuff.
Dude, this is so crazy. How did these guys like find each other and mobilize? I don't get that. They're like, you know what, guys? We're in the happiest place on earth. Which one of you guys likes kitties? Well, I like kitties. I'm like, all right, cool. Let's come over here and talk in this room. How the fuck does this happen?
I don't know.
Is there code? They're like, I like pizza. And you're like, oh, you like pizza? I was like, yeah, man. I like slice of pizza. What?
Actually, it's hot dogs.
That's Pizzagate, right?
Pizzagate is what it's called, but the code word for little boys and stuff was hot dogs.
Hot dogs?
How do you know this?
They couldn't get a little bit
because
more creative?
Because I read...
Fuck.
I read all in the Pizzagate stuff on some of the subreddits and...
nauseous.
Stuff.
That makes me... Wow. That makes me so nauseous.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. Disney hasn't really come out and said anything about it yet. It was...
they're going to keep that, you know... the low.
Well, either that,
or you go either Catholic Church on you.
Well, you know, because you see that finally blew up for the Catholic Church. So I mean, eventually they're going to have to come out. They're going to have to say
listen,
something.
Man, you cannot deny urges, human urges, or else you end up serving fucking kids. So just don't be celibate like that.
Oh, okay.
You get what I'm saying? Do you get what I'm saying?
Are they allowed to, you know?
They're not allowed to have sex. So
what about sex with themselves?
They're not allowed to do that either.
Yeah, no, that's frowned upon in Catholic Church, which is really interesting because back before the Crusades and stuff like that, they could actually get married.
Yeah, so weird.
Priests could they could be married. They could have a family, and I can't remember which pope it was, but he changed that. I think he changed it during the Crusades.
Was that Pope ugly?
I don't know. I'm not a history major, and I'm
listen, man. Butchering. If I can't get none, you can't get none either.
God damn it! I was just gonna say that.
You know what, man? You know what that means? I'm just one step faster than you, sir.
I guess so.
There it is.
He must be the youth.
It's my youth.
It's his enlightenment since he's got into cryptocurrency. His brain's operating on a whole new level.
Listen, man, I also did this thing for the first time, too. I used money from my phone, and I just scanned that shit at the register, and I bought stuff.
You did a little Apple Pay?
I did.
How'd you like it?
I did. I used my Apple Wallet, and I was like, hey, man, do you have that scanning deal you opened my phone? They're like, yeah, man, hang it over there. I was like, boop. All right, 908, got it done. Did it at Kohl's. Look, it's right here.
See, I still haven't got on that bandwagon yet.
Did it.
Since I do cash... I'm a little skeptical on
this. Listen, man.
Those envelopes.
You need to come out from those dark ages.
Nah.
Hey,
homies.
Bracing.
Yo. What?
I have an appointment with Santa with the family, so I'm going to go ahead and get going.
Hey, tell Santa.
You're going to go sit on Santa's lap?
Podcast tomorrow, guys.
Hey, all right. Listen, if Santa pops a chubby when he sees you.
Why would you say that? That's horrible.
Because it's going to happen.
Yeah.
He's going to be with his kids.
Santa Claus what?
Nothing. Don't worry about it. It's horrible.
Listen, when you sit on his lap, Robbie, he's gonna pop a chubby. Just know that because you're looking sexy now.
Well, this is I don't think I'll be sitting on his lap, but I appreciate the advice.
Maybe he'll sit on yours.
All right. Yeah. About that.
Yeah.
No, thank you.
I'm just trying to save him some money so he doesn't go.
All right. We love you, Robbie.
Some Bitcoin. All right, guys. You all keep your dirty minds over there. I'll talk to y'all later.
Later, brother. Bye, Robbie.
Peace out, guys.
Bye.
But yeah, I was just reading that on one of the subreddits yesterday about Disney, and I was like, man, that sucks.
And here you are supporting them every weekend.
I know. There's the thing, man. It starts getting weird. Like, you're an enabler. Well, the thing is you can't look at. I don't think you can look at Disney as a whole. You know, that would be like, okay, let's say
I look at it as a money pit.
Well, let's look at it like this. Okay, that's so true. if somebody in our system is an asshole, do you attach the whole system?
I don't trust any place that charges $8 for a water.
That right there is another inside joke, man. That's five for today. Boom, I'm on fire.
You're keeping track?
Yeah, I kept track.
Anyway, so I mean,
and you guys know three of the inside jokes.
But so, okay, so Disney had 27 employees out of however many thousand that they employ in Orlando.
And they only caught.
That's true. They only caught 27 in the sting. But I mean, but do you blame Disney? Do you go, you know what, I have to pull everything that I can't go to Disney now because that would be supporting those 27 people.
Well, you've already supported them enough. I mean, I know. You're there every weekend.
Don't you own stock in Disney? Aren't you like a part owner?
No, Disney stock is pretty outrageous.
I mean, hell, it's like you did it yourself.
What?
don't you have a house in the grounds?
No.
In the grounds?
No.
Don't you have a special parking that you put your $900,000 trailer on?
I wish.
With your little porch and tiki torches and
that'd
shit?
Be super dope if I did.
With the antenna for DirecTV?
No, I don't have that yet. I don't have that yet.
That's not how my house should look.
So while we're talking, Art is just looking at butts and puppies.
No. Oh, you must be on Instagram.
No, that's all these Rottweilers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want 6 of them too. I want a half dozen. Half dozen Rottweilers. That's what I want.
You know this is what he's going to do with his Bitcoin. Once it hits it big and all like that, he is going to get that compound. He's going to have all that acreage so he can have all the dogs.
Six. Why six, guys? Because that means it's three on each side of me. I can manage that. I can manage six on each side. Three on each side.
Think so? You think
six on each side. That was a Freudian slip. I want six on each side. 12. I would like 12 dogs.
You want 12?
12 Rottweilers.
24. Let's up it.
Nah, 20. That's when you start getting to where you can't handle.
No. Once we hit 24, I gotta have backup. Who wants to live with me?
You gotta put them on a rotating schedule.
No,
all at once.
No, they're all at once.
We're walking them all.
Look
at
these trained. They're trained.
I need that person.
Bro, you do. Cause your dogs keep biting things.
People, crazy
dogs. Other dogs.
They just get TVs. Crazy.
Yeah.
No, that was my kid's fault. I'm not gonna say that wasn't.
That's called a roll dog. Look, guys, it's a little puppy.
They can't see that.
I know, man. I wish they could. You're missing out. God damn.
I wish you put your phone away for like a little bit so we could do a podcast.
Should I go dark?
At least for like maybe 15 minutes or so.
I don't know. We've only been doing the podcast for a little over a year now, and you've never went dark for a podcast, but yet you went dark yesterday.
I know. That kind of bothers me. Yeah.
What were you doing? I had some stuff I had to do, man.
We want your attention, and you're giving it away.
No, I usually give it away to people, but I'd take a couple hours myself.
That's
just
good.
Just beer for life.
You should do that every now and then.
Sometimes I...
preferably on Sundays from 1 to 3.
See what that is? That was a layer, Wallow. That's how you do it.
Whatever. My jokes are simple.
Hey, hold on, let me fist this one out.
My jokes are simple, Jack, bro.
Never go full retard, bro.
Never go full retard.
Everybody can understand them, except you.
Goddamn, I love that movie. We actually watched it the other day.
We got to add that to the list, so Die Hard.
Oh, God.
Simple Jack.
It's such a good movie. It's just, it's
I'm so hungry. You guys hungry?
No, not really.
Let's go eat.
Can we do a podcast before we go eat?
Why are you so
It's 4 o'clock right now.
Yeah, because you got here at 2.
No, I got here at 1:30.
You only had a bagel.
I got here at 1:20. I've only had a bagel and 2 coffees a day.
You should have got the omelet.
Well, I'm so hungry. The omelet would have done. Actually, you know what? I also had some eggs and tomato and rice when I got home, and I had another coffee.
Listen,
so
I want to.
I've had 3 coffees today.
I want to talk about Nikki Ryan calling out all the 10 Planet Black Belts.
Yeah, I don't think Nikki Ryan should call out the 10 Planet Black Belts. You're 16, my man. I mean, you are an amazing talent. You absolutely are. You will be going against these guys here in the future, just not right now.
But why
not let him get humbled a little bit?
Why is he going to Geo first? He's got to deal with other ninjas, man.
But why?
We got plenty of other ninjas in your belt ring this week. Yeah, you beat Marvin. Okay, good. Congratulations to you. No, he's playing footsies with you. Shouldn't have done that. And you beat, who was it, Lewis?
Ricky Lilly.
Ricky Lilly. You'd be Ricky Lilly too, and that's outstanding for you, buddy. But no, I mean, I understand, Wallo, you think he should do it, right?
I actually see both sides.
I see both sides. Why would Gio entertain this?
Why wouldn't he?
Well, he be Eddie Cummings. Can Ricky Nicky Ryan be Eddie Cummings?
I don't know. I never seen him.
Yeah, okay. So he start beating somebody like Eddie Cummings, and then he shouldn't get a shot at Gio. Gio's a different level. I'm sorry. Marvin's amazing.
Well, he's not calling out Eddie Cummings though.
No. He's calling out Gio, who beat Eddie Cummings. Can he even beat Eddie Cummings? No, he can't. Get out of here.
Here's my point. I understand your point, but there was a ranking system put out there. I don't know of all 10 Planet competitors. You know, number 1 through 25.
Listen, man, that wasn't in order. Is that what you're talking about? The ranking thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw the whole thing go down. That's not in order. That's just like, hey, man, who do you think should be in the top? Da, da, da. They just start throwing out names. Well, of course, Gio's number one, but drop it on down. So, I mean, there's plenty of
people. Yeah, well, the thing is you were in the know. Nobody else is. So that list has gone out into the wind. So yeah. People look
at it. That's exactly what
people they don't know. That's not our ranking order of like who's the best in the system or something. But that's just like those good competitors.
Well listen. Based on what we see online and everything, those are the guys that are winning. You know, the guys in the top 10, those are the guys that are killing it.
Yeah. They're all killers, man.
If you look at the 145ers that are on there on the top 10, Marvin, Ricky Lilly, and Gio.
Yeah. Well,
why, you know,
let him hit some of the brown belts first, man. Yeah. He beat Marvin, whatever, you know, but on any given, day, you beat anybody has certain things, man. He's just like, no, he shouldn't get a chance at Gio yet.
I understand.
He's going at 145 and he's 16.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a big kid.
Damn, that's a big kid.
Yeah, he's a big kid. He's tall too. Like I said, the kid's telling him, I'm not taking anything away from him for sure. You know what I mean? But come on, man. You can't go straight up to that.
Why not? He's beaten two on the top three.
He's taken step three and step two. So now he's.
Yeah.
I kind of want to see it.
I agree with Gio. It's a lose-lose situation. Look, kid's a purple belt. Okay.
Yeah.
So if he's beating black belts at that level, hey, so maybe he should be going up in rank. But there's plenty of other jokers that he could be grappling with first.
But what is he losing though?
What is who losing?
Gio.
Gio's losing because if he wins,
yeah.
So what? He beat a purple belt. So what?
It doesn't matter that
if he loses, that's a big lose.
It doesn't matter that Nicky Ryan's attached to that purple belt.
No, motherfucker.
All right.
See, that's how you know you got me irritated. I said, motherfucker.
You always call me a
Why are you irritated? We're just having a conversation.
I don't know, but it's irritating me.
Why is it
irritating? Because you're like, man, why can't he, man? I'm telling you why. You're like, why? I'm like, listen, man.
Is Gio afraid to lose?
Gio's definitely not afraid to lose.
I think
it's a lose-lose situation. He doesn't get anything from it. What does he get from it? What did he get? Oh, you beat Nicky Ryan. Well, you're supposed to beat Nicky Ryan. So it's not a big deal. Why? He wants people like Gary Tonin. He wants other gangsters.
Gary retired.
So that's retired. Not going to happen because he retired. So.
Yeah, he retired for like a minute.
Has Gio and Gordon went?
Well, Gordon's too big, man.
Gordon's like 200.
97 pounds of solid
Gordon's,
muscle.
You're talking about Gordon 5.0 right now, man. You can't. Come on, dude. Come on, man.
I didn't realize he was that big until I saw him in
EBI. He's big, bro. Like, he's big. Jesus he's Christ. Taller than Brian, and Brian's not a small guy at all.
I just don't understand the lose-lose thing. Maybe.
How do you don't think it's a lose-lose?
Why? Yeah.
If he beats him, like, what does he win? He doesn't get – you're supposed to beat him. It's a lose. And if he loses against him, that's a big loss.
Yeah, but people would say that Nicky Ryan's a phenom.
So?
So that would be
What's
your
point. So is Gio. That's how he made black belt.
It
like
just
three,
seems like
years.
They're more focused on if he loses, then it's a like a huge deal. And I get it.
I just don't see what the big deal is.
He has nothing to gain. Why would he do something if he doesn't nothing to gain? But man, listen, man. Yeah, you beat two other black belts, cool, your brothers. But there's levels of this shit. There is.
Okay. Well, then maybe he wants to try out the new level.
Hey, man. If they say cool, but he's saying not cool, so I back him on that.
I mean, like ADCC, you see purple belts going against black belts, and they have
that's cool. It's ADCC. This is private. This is a professional tournament. This is professional submission
only.
Okay, so
he does gain something. He gains money. Isn't this why the pro tournaments are out there to make some money?
Listen, man, he wants a bigger name than Nicky Ryan. Nicky Ryan's not a big name. I mean, he's big, but he's not a big name. Not compared to like some of these other cats. Just saying he wants bigger names.
Okay, well, Tonus.
He's making a splash. Don't get me wrong, dude's good.
Yeah.
Bro, I don't want to roll with him. Probably whip my ass too. I'm just saying.
He will whip my ass in like 5 seconds.
Well, I mean, you don't have enough confidence.
I kind of want to see him go with his brother.
Oh,
like I'll pay, for real.
I'll pay to see that too.
Oh, Gordon probably smash him. Like, I know.
Not just
about
a training round. Like, I want to see them go at it like they do EBI or whatever.
You want to see little Ryan versus big Ryan?
Hell yeah.
You know, the big brother's got to win, bro.
Yeah, I don't want to. I don't know if I really want to watch a 145 or go up against a 245.
Why not? You had Mackenzie Dern go against Gabby Garcia.
Yeah, you just wanted to see Ryan against Gio. Why not? Ryan.
I didn't put the two weights together. I thought Gio was bigger than that.
Oh,
yeah,
Gio's tiny. Retard, then.
Yeah. Oh, well, maybe.
You're a retard. No, man, you got to give him a break.
And that's a simple Jack joke. I mean, I do see both sides, but I like to see it.
I made you a jackalope. There it is.
Maybe it's because I don't compete professionally that I don't see the loose. So maybe that's why I'm.
Yeah, I mean, we as fans, yeah, we'd like to see it, sure. And I mean, I'm sure we will one day.
And don't will, and that's what he says.
And
he
don't get me wrong, just, if it happens, it will happen. It's not right now. I'm Team Gio all the way.
He probably wants it on his own terms and not because he got called out
by a 16-year-old.
Touche.
Could be.
Maybe he's playing mind game.
Miggy, where are you?
Strong possibility.
Yeah.
Gio's a smart guy, man. I actually just did a seminar with him this other weekend, man.
How did that go?
It went great.
Because you weren't here.
He showed me some cool shit. Yep. He showed me some real cool shit, man. In fact, I went over that shit all week.
Oh, yeah. Dude,
How to crush those legs, man. How to crush those legs so they can't even get near your legs.
I like the little things we went over on our class with the legs.
Listen, man, that's all Gio and Boogie, man.
That was dope. I was like, you know what? I know exactly who's going to put me in this position, and I cannot wait.
Oh, you want to say who?
No.
Oh, okay.
I don't call people out like that.
Can you have a code word so when it happens, we can watch?
Oh, yeah. I will. I'll be like, it's here.
Big watermelon.
Line. Are you a little salty?
No, I'm not salty. you know who gets salty? That's ooh. Young kids who haven't grown up or lived a life. Those are people that get salty. I don't get salty.
I get salty.
What do you get salty about?
I don't know. I'm lying. I just wanted. Stuff. I wanted to be an antagonist, man.
Yeah. What do you get salty about?
I'm not really salty. Well, I do get salty about stuff.
I get aggravated about shit all the time.
I get salty about stuff like when you. This is the deal, man. You know, I always try to take the high road and do all that stuff. But, man, sometimes I get a little irritated about it because no matter what I do, you know, positively, then sometimes, you know, people say things or do things that I just really, 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 really don't like. And it has nothing to do with me, but it affects me and that bothers me. Then I get a little salty there. I get salty. It's true.
I guess it's okay to get salty as long as you don't dwell on being salty. As long as that's not your thing.
Well, I'm still dwelling on it. So it's been like 4 days now, 3-4 days.
Speaking of salty, did you all see AJ's post after he lost to Nate?
Jesus.
No, what happened?
Oh, my God.
You didn't see it?
Dude, he went on to a whole fucking spiel about how
it was like this big.
Like it wasn't really a real tournament. He wasn't really trying.
That he wasn't his rule. That the rule set was not fair or something like that. I'm like, what?
Yeah, but yeah,
Nate had the same set of rules that you did.
Yeah, but yet whenever AJ won against somebody by that same rule set, it was the fucking I'm the man. Fuck that guy. God, I hate AJ.
I think a lot of people don't like him. He's the one who's always getting smack fest with people, right?
So
yeah, yes. Jake Shields just fucking slapped the dog shit out of him.
He tried. He actually slapped Chael trying to slap AJ.
Chael Sonnen?
Yeah. Chael Sonnen was doing an interview with Jake Shields in the cage
after their match.
After the match that AJ had, Jake Shields had, mm-hmm. And he was calling out people, and he said, "I wouldn't mind slapping AJ Agasarm." Whatever, however the fuck you pronounce his last name, around a little bit more. And I guess AJ was in the crowd and he went into the cage and, they started, you know, spewing back and forth and, fucking Jake Shields tried to slap him and, Shields on.
Oh, I did see that. I saw that.
Yeah. Well, cause I think in the past, Jake has slapped him.
At Polaris.
Yeah. Slapped the shit out of him.
Cause,
combat jiu-jitsu should happen.
I know. That would be awesome.
I would like to see AJ come and do some combat jiu-jitsu
against him or Wagner Rocha.
Dude, Wagner is the fucking truth, man. God dang.
What?
He's good.
Yeah,
I watched him live.
I know. That's why crazy. I said it.
It's crazy, Wagner, the guy.
He kind of did that at, was it Fight to Win?
Where he kicked him in the back? Yeah.
Yeah. Kicked him off the mat.
Yeah, because I guess AJ wasn't engaging.
Yeah, he turned his back.
He turned his back.
I want to see that.
This is Sparta.
Who kicked AJ?
Wagner.
Yeah, that was Wagner.
Yeah.
Dude, that was so funny.
That was like a year ago.
Yeah, that was a while ago.
Didn't they overturn that win or whatever? They did something with it.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
They made it no contest, or they did something with it.
I'm going to be honest, man. It's okay.
But did you all see that Gordon won last night again?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Last 2 weeks in a row? Yeah.
So yeah. That arm must be okay.
Yeah, because he choked out Yuri Simoes.
Yeah, surprisingly.
Well,
yeah.
It's not any stuff.
Hey, don't you have a Yuri story there, Sherry?
Do you want to share it?
I don't care. I just thought it was probably a year and a half ago or something. And
it was during EBI 6.
It was right after.
I saw the private messages.
Yeah. So did I.
You
want to read them? Oh, shit.
He had been messaging me and I wasn't really responding.
This is on which platform?
Instagram.
Okay. So he's sliding up in your DMs. Okay. Got you.
Yeah. So he was messaging me and I really wasn't paying him any attention. And he basically started going like, you know, most girls would love that I'm messaging them and blah, blah, blah. And pull it up.
You're like, I don't even know who you are yet. What? Huh?
Was it because he wore a rash guard that only had one sleeve that you didn't like it? No.
What?
You didn't see his rash guard for EBI-6?
Uh-uh.
It only had one sleeve and the other one was cut off.
The hell?
Yeah.
No. But really?
Yeah. You guys didn't see that?
I didn't. I'm...
Okay. I had been ignoring him or whatever, and he goes, but hey, don't be cold to me. Lots of girls would want to get an IG message from me. You should feel lucky I'm into you. Something about your gingerness. And I was like, oh, really? And he said, really what, though? That you should feel lucky or that I like your gingerness. And I said that I should feel lucky. He goes, blessed would fit better. At least start talking, taking me more seriously. You know that I ain't just a talker. And I didn't respond.
You should respond now and go, hey, great match.
Well, my thing was like, I only date winners. Hashtag Gordon. Hashtag Gordon Ryan.
That is cold.
That's how douchey is that to message some random girl you've never met? Like, he kept trying to say, like, come to California. I never really responded. Like,
that's weird. This is Instagram for sure. Huh?
Interesting.
Weird. Listen, man, you're so lucky. Listen, I wasn't even into you, bitch. You're probably gay. I'm sure of it.
Did you have
how many girls is he telling that to?
Like, probably like 70. Come on.
We're good.
Yeah, I mean, it's like a cast net. You just throw it out there, copy and paste, and you see if you get some bites.
You should be lucky.
Listen,
you should
be lucky. I should have
been like, who are you?
I could have slid up in any DM.
I'm not gonna, you know, talk too much shit about him because, you know, in my 20s, I did some shit like that.
Is he 20?
Did you?
I don't know.
No, he's in his 40s.
I think. I'm about to say. That's
not, no, I'm just saying.
That's not the hairline of a 20-year-old.
But I'm saying that I did stupid shit like that in my 20s. You know, I used to go to the clubs.
You were a kid.
And girls used to.
Your frontal cortex hadn't developed yet.
Yeah.
I guess. That's the right term for it.
26,
right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Girls used to come in and be like, hey, how about you buy me a drink? I'm like, how about you buy me a drink?
Like
I was some fucking god or something.
Do you know who I am?
You know
I am well known on my island.
Yeah, it's my island.
My island. And we steal generators.
Yeah. Have you ever heard of a little island called Puerto Rico?
I own it.
That's me. Puerto Rico.
Yeah. So I'm not going to, you know.
But no, anyways, I was happy to see he lost because he's.
Oh, yeah. I mean, anytime a douche gets to lose, it's always a great feeling.
I don't know. I haven't met him, so I really can't say that he's.
Yeah, it's one of those things where just based off of those messages, yeah, I don't really think that's somebody I want to get. You know,
I know. I'm just kidding.
I don't think I'm going to give you a chance to be a cool. I'm not going to be like, yo, I know you were kind of douchey and one of my friends' DMs. You know, let's really see if you really are that guy.
He'd be like, bro, you know how many chicks I hit him?
Yeah. Then I'll be
I don't know your friend.
I'd be like, all right, well, cool.
Anyway.
Good night.
Before we go, let's give a shout out to our official sponsor.
Oh, hold on. There is something I did want to talk about.
Oh, go ahead.
I'm sorry. I meant to bring it up earlier, but before we end, I just want to see. What's up? Has anybody seen the little boy that's been going on Facebook?
Crying?
The little one that got bullied.
Yeah, I feel so bad for that guy.
Keaton.
Yeah.
Dude. The outpouring of support that's come in from him from everywhere.
Dana White said something.
Dana's called out to his family wanting to bring him out to Vegas.
Oh, wow.
Let's see.
So what's the backstory?
Anyways, his mom took a video of him. She had to come pick him up from school, and he was upset because the kids were bullying him and picking on him, making fun of him.
Uh-huh. You know, this is the thing. Is like, so he was born with a cleft lip palate.
And his nose is wide.
Okay. Yeah, and he has a scar on his lip or whatever.
Uh-huh.
So he has a little bit of deformity compared to what we would consider an average kid. But anyways, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah. So Dana's hit him up. I know a couple of the tactical pages that I follow on Instagram. They've hit his family up. They've said, you know, let us, we, a lot of people are going, you know, hey, what school does he go to? Where is he at? We would love to come and sit with him for lunch. You know, a lot of the operators that I follow on Instagram, the special forces guys, they want to go.
Didn't the okay, Vols, so tell me, Tennessee, so he Titans. Got,
yeah, yeah, the Vols, the football team, because he's in Tennessee. I think he's in Knoxville.
So the kid got bullied at school.
Yeah, so his mom just took a video of it, kind of.
Well, this is the deal. It's like, you know, this happened. So she did take a video, but he wanted her to take the video.
Yeah.
So she didn't just like out no, him, you know. No. What I mean?
She's like, he asked like, for the video to be taken.
You know, and then I watched the whole video and I was like pretty upset about it. You know, and I wrote this big long thing and then, I mean, I ended up deleting it because I was like, hey, that's just going to get, you know, it's just in the wind. Enough people already said exactly how I felt about it. So, yeah, it's really sad, you know, and then she's like, you know, what do you feel about it basically? And he's like, you know, it will get better, so on and so forth. I just got to stay strong. And I was like, oh, yeah, this kid, you know, he's hearing all the right things. He's saying the right things. He has the right mentality. It obviously hurts, you know, words hurt. It's just, it's frustrating for me to see, you know, that little kiddo in that much pain, you know, and I don't even like people. Just saying.
What's cool is the UFC actually put a little video together for him.
Did they?
Yeah. It had Daniel Cormier, Tyron Woodley, Paul Felder, Rashad Evans, Kenny Florian, they were all in a little video that the UFC Twitter put out.
Wow.
You know, just telling them, hey, you've got friends here. You know, we support you. We love you. You know, and just shit like that. So it's like, man, it's kind of one of those things that reminds you, because I go through it sometimes with my kids. But, man, goddamn, kids are just assholes.
Well, there was that girl, 13-year-old, that just killed herself, what, last week or the week before?
Yeah.
And they're still getting bullied. Like, her parents are still getting messages about this girl. I don't understand. Like, these kids need to be taken care of.
Well, I think, you know, man, it's tough. It's, every generation's like, well, the new generation's softer, so on and so forth. And this has been going on forever. But now it's actually coming to light. You're seeing what these kiddos are going through, and you're seeing these suicides, which have happened since I was a kid, you know, and I remember being a kid and getting picked on at certain levels and grades and stuff like that before I was like more popular or felt more comfortable in my own skin. And I felt the exact same way that kid did. And you know what I mean? I didn't even have a handicap like how he did, or not a handicap, but like a disfigurement like how he did. You know what I mean? So I can only imagine. You can only imagine.
Man, yeah, getting bullied only made you stronger, at least when I was growing up.
Well, the problem is nowadays is, okay, so you got a bully in school. They bully you. They fuck with you constantly.
Then they fuck with you online.
Until you fuck them up. But the problem is, though, as soon as you fuck them up, though,
then you're in trouble.
You're in trouble.
You fucked them up. Yeah.
You fucked them up. Now, when I went to school, it was because I had bullies. You know, kid bullied me for half a year until one day I'd finally had enough in the locker room because he tried to take my jacket. He's like, this is mine now. I beat the dog shit out of him. I beat his head into a locker. Dina Boys was asking me what happened. Told him, hey, kid's been fucking with me for 6 months. Finally had enough. Beat his ass. Dean was like, cool. You get one day of ISSP. No big deal.
What the hell is that?
In-school suspension. Yeah. So basically, you sit in a classroom and you get, basically, I got to sit in a classroom and do schoolwork. So I really didn't miss a day of school. I didn't get suspended. I didn't get expelled. But that's the way you handled bullies back then. Yeah. Kid fuck with you. You either the kid that was getting bully snapped, or like what we used to do on the football team is we would actually find out who was, you know, if we saw kids getting bullied. All right, cool. You think you're cool enough to bully some other kid? Guess what? We're going to come over and fuck you up now. So like the whole defensive line would just go and sit with the kid. Be like, yeah, come say something now. Because as soon as you do, guess what? There's going to be three of us that are going to beat the shit out of you. You just scare them. Then they go, oh, fuck. I'm not that big. I'm not that cool.
Yeah.
I'll back off now. And we did that shit all the time.
Man, I didn't wait 6 months, bro, when I was growing up. Nah, well, fuck that.
Well, I had enough.
I give you two passes on the third. That's it.
See, the school I went to, though, I had enough issues to deal with that he wasn't that high on the list. Because I was having to worry about a lot of other shit coming from a lot of other directions.
The church?
I went to Rebalt.
I don't even know what that means.
Rebalt's been a bad – it was a bad school back then.
It's a shitty school. It's always been a shitty school.
We used to literally take our knives and we would put them under the fence in the back of the school because you had to go through metal detectors to come into the school. So and then before class, we'd go back and get our knives because they bust us all the way from over here to there. So – I mean, it was shit. So this kid was not high on my radar, but eventually he did. He got moved up the list. After that, guess what? Didn't get fucked with.
So you're like Arya Stark. You had a list.
Oh, I had a back in those days in that school. Yeah, you made a list.
You just made the list.
I'm sorry, that's a wrestling.
Congratulations.
Thing.
But oh, what? What?
I mean, these were my list. Back in those days, man, girls were getting raped in the bathroom.
Oh my God!
What kind of craziness is that?
One kid hung himself in the bathroom.
Jesus,
getting bullied, just hung himself. Damn. The kids from the senior side, because Rebolt Junior and Rebolt Senior were right side by side. So the seniors would actually come over to the school and start fights, try to beat up, you know, the younger kids and shit like that. So there wasn't a whole lot of education going on other than learning how to fight, who your friends were, how to protect yourself, you know.
Real life shit.
Real life shit. I mean, really. And it was funny, too, because we used to laugh and joke because Amanda went to the other bad school. She went to Highlands. So it was always kind of a little competition of who was the shittiest school? Yeah, who was the shittiest
school? Awesome.
Our school bus got shot up one day going over there. We got 3 bullet holes in the school bus going through the neighborhood to get to Rebolt. Yeah, it was shit, bro. But so, yeah, so when I saw that.
Sounds like you were born in Iraq, man.
No, just had to go through Rebolt area, Moncrief, shit like that. But so when I saw this little video, I was like, man, goddamn, this sucks. I just hate kids. You know, sometimes it's like, man, kids are such little assholes. But I'm really glad to see there's been a huge outpouring of support for him. So hopefully hopefully it gets better. I mean, it always does. As you grow up, it gets better. But that's what I've tried to explain to Tegan, because she has that shit sometimes. This girl says this, or so-and-so says this. It's like, baby, guess what? Just ignore him, because in 10 years, you're not even going to fucking talk to him. You're not even going to know him. You probably won't even remember their names.
Seems like my daughter's become like the enforcer in our neighbor. She comes home and talks about kids being bullied, and that she'll step in, and because she's a big girl, she's tall, you know, she looks like an adult, and all of a sudden she steps in the middle and she's like, now the kid doesn't bother that kid anymore.
Yeah, we had to do that.
The Punisher.
We
kind of is.
That's what we did. We would see
she's
somebody
bossy
getting
though too.
We'd see somebody getting jumped at Rebolt. That was your job. You got in there and you even the odds, even up the numbers.
Even if he was an enemy.
Hey, it was, because unfortunately at Rebolt, man, it was a total color game. That's all it was. It sucked. It was white versus black. That's
bro,
all it was.
I went to Sandalwood for 1 year, or Sandalweed as they call it.
Yeah.
And bro, I've never been in such a what happened? You just dropped your headphones.
Yeah. Caught it on his mind.
You know, in Puerto Rico, we don't have that racial divide that's here.
So in Puerto Rico, we are poor. That's why we call it Puerto Rico.
What the fuck? I didn't say I came from the pipeline of Alaska.
Jesus.
I didn't either.
I said Puerto Rico.
Did I say anything about a pipeline?
Yeah, I Alaska? Did.
I'm from Anchorage.
You didn't have a cable TV or from electricity.
Anchorage. Or electricity.
So anyway.
But they got it now. How about Puerto Rico?
Generators, bro.
Yeah, stolen from.
Yeah, whatever.
It don't matter where they came from. We got them.
But see, I didn't know Sandalwood was like that, though.
No, that's
funny. Yeah, man. Guys, I love my Puerto Rican friends. The blacks kept to the blacks. Filipinos kept to the Filipinos, and the white guys kept to the white guys. Man, I couldn't understand why they weren't friends with other people. They just stuck together, and there was a big deal with. The blacks and the Filipinos fighting all the time.
The blacks didn't like the Filipinos?
I guess not.
What the fuck, man?
I don't know.
See, at Rebolt, it was almost one of these where it was a rule set. Like, you couldn't be friends. If you were caught being friends with somebody that wasn't of your color, then you were either not protected. If you were getting jumped, nobody was coming.
I think I seen this in a movie.
It was a prison movie. Yeah.
Prison movie.
I mean.
Listen, man, you got to get V'd in, man. You need to get that swastika on your forehead.
It's called American Me.
Well, the crazy thing is like we had riot doors there. So anytime a big fight broke out, they would just hit the button and you got locked into whatever block you were in.
Bro, listen, that's called prison.
That's not school.
I think you're confusing your TV shows with your school.
No.
It's not 9 through 12. That's
Yeah, he's like, yeah, man, I was on block 9.
No, we did. We had
for a whole year. Then I moved to block 10 and 11 and 12.
We had A block. We had A block, B block, C block, and D block.
I'm telling you, that's prison.
No,
that's
prison.
That's C block.
Were there bars on the window?
No.
Okay, well, that's because the windows are on the fourth floor.
That's an upgrade. No, because I still remember the layout of the school, because A block was to the left, and then it went down left to right.
All right, guys. Well, let's Let's end this on a good note before we go.
Before Chris gets us all depressed about his prison school.
No, this was actually a good thing for the Keaton kids. So I'm actually glad that, you know, somebody, the support's coming out of all the woodwork for him. So.
Yeah, you think you have it bad. I went to school in prison.
Nah.
Well, give a shout out to our official sponsor.
Yeah, man, I would like to give a shout out to Lean Impact Nutrition. Thank you for all the nutritional guidance. And it's like I'm saying a prayer right now. And keep me on my macros and get me ready for my super fight.
Super fight?
Getting ready. 185. Only got 100 pounds to go. Great. And then we'd also like to thank Black Hive Tattoo right now. If you go to blackhivetattoo.com, there is the golden ticket. Sign up for that and you can get yourself a tattoo. Cause normally they're out there for a while as far as wait time. So jump on that this month now. Do it now. And then we have X training fitness equipment. And again, Fasty for all your home and gym fitness equipment needs. Give them a call. They'll get you set up.
Cryotherapy Jacks
for your post-recovery needs. That is when you're having a hard week of training. The only way that you're going to get better is if you're recovered. You can't keep training at that level without proper recovery. You need to have proper nutrition, lean and practice nutrition. You need a proper body recovery. You need fresh oxygen and new blood through each one of those limbs that are just being torn up. You get that through your cryotherapy and your pneumatic compression. Get to it.
All right. We don't have anything else, right? No other sponsors? Shut up. No, we don't. Anyway, guys, our website, lrtlk.com, has been updated with our shop. So if
get
you,
the t-shirts.
That's right. If you guys were telling me, oh, I want a t-shirt, the shop's up. So we're going to have a 3-week pre-order. Place your order. Once the 3 weeks are up, that's it. We're going to close the shop and we're done with that shirt. So get to it. And also, don't forget, we have an Amazon banner. If you shop on Amazon, use our banner for every purchase that you make. Amazon gives us a little kickback, just as a little bonus. Guys, anything else that we want to talk about or anything else that we didn't cover?
No, sir.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you very much, guys, for listening. We appreciate your support. And we'll catch you next week. Peace.
Party people, can you get funky? So sign and force, can you get funky? The Zulu Nation, can you get funky? Yeah, just hit me. Just taste the funk and hit me. Just get on down and hit me. Bam, bam, just get so funky now, hit me. Yeah, just hit me.
It's time to chase your dreams. Up out the seats, make your body sway. Socialize, get down. Let your soul lead the way. Shake it now,
go ladies.
It's a living dream.
Love, life, live.
Come play
the game.
Our world is free.
Do what you want, but free.
just get on down and hit me. And bottles get so fucking out, hit me.
Other piece of the world.
Spread the message of our world.
Men, women, boys, and girls.
Hey, our planet rock is so working on it.
You got the groove. Move.
Shaboom, do, shaboom. Shot, feel the groove. Feel it.
Do what you want to, but you know you got to be cool and boogie.
Out on the floor.
Go down,
bring it low. Close to the ground.
And everybody just rocking, don't stop it. We gotta rock it, don't stop.
Working all around the clock.
Everybody just rocking, don't stop it.
We gotta rock it, don't stop.
Keep ticking and talking.
Working all around the clock.
Everybody gotta rock it, don't stop it.
You gotta rock it, don't stop it.
You gotta rock it, don't stop it.
You gotta rock it, don't stop.
You gotta rock it, don't stop it.